Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How you guys doing today? One second, por favor. Getting things a little more ready. Readier than what they are. Give me one second. Just getting my Streamlabs up. Getting my chat up. And we need to load a bowl and we should be ready to go. Get that chat. What's up, Azrael? Thanks for joining, man. I appreciate it. Azrael says, nice shirt, bro. Thank you, man. I like it. There's a lot of people in Colorado that actually moved here from California. So it's the main reason why I got it. yo, Ariel, what's up, man? Ariel says, hey, Sony, glad to see you again. Nice haircut. Yeah, thank you, man. Yeah, I got it the other day. And thank you for joining as well. I appreciate that big time. Very, very much appreciated. And yeah, what's up, guys? Thank you so much for joining me today. Hold on one second. I need to get my microphone adjusted, lifting it up a little bit. This will be the last time I have to do this. This Saturday, well, okay, so Saturday will be the last time I have to do this. Or Friday, I should say. Because Saturday, well, today, I just ordered a brand new microphone stand. And I should be getting a badass brand new microphone as well pretty soon. It just depends. But I got one of those microphone stands, like the little boom mics where you could hook them up to your desk or your you could clamp them onto whatever you're streaming at, you know, and it'll stay there, and you could adjust its height, you could adjust where it's at, you know. It should be coming Saturday, so Friday should be the last day I have to adjust my microphone like this, and I'll just be able to have it hanging here, you know. It'll be real nice. It's gonna be real good. But yeah, hey, we got Logan Cooley in the chat. Says, can't chill watching Harry Potter, had to say hey and drop a like. Hell yeah, dude, thank you, I appreciate that. And no worries, we'll see you next time, dude, for sure. But thanks for dropping in, I definitely appreciate it. Let's see here. Alright, so just a heads up about the Wounded Warrior Project donation. I haven't been able to make it yet, but it will be happening real soon. I will throw it up on like Twitter and stuff like that, so you guys could check it out and you know, see the process. And I'll drop a link, so if anybody else wants to give directly to the Wounded Warrior Project, y'all are able to do that for sure. But this upcoming on this next month, for what is this? We did it for April, so okay, so this month, May, the end of the month, we're going to be doing another one, and I believe it's going to be for Fuck Cancer or something like that. Logan Cooley had suggested one that he wanted us to do, and I still need to look into it, but yeah, it's most likely going to be something like that, because I don't remember us having a different one scheduled for this month. But yeah, it'll be cool, it'll be real nice. Let's see here, looking for my weed. I'm a little behind, I'm sorry guys. It's called, audio says it's called Movie 2, right? I'm a little lost on that, audio. I apologize. I'm not too sure if you're referring to me or not, but yeah, I'm not too sure what you mean. But let's see. Let's throw you guys up on the gameplay. Got me more Caribulus today. Got me some more Malibu. And I'm actually making it with Sunny D this time. I tried it a little while back, and it was actually really good. Really liked it. And it's a little bit of a switch up from pineapple juice. Just because, I mean, it was starting to get, I was starting to get too accustomed to it, you know. It was time for a little bit of a change, a little bit of an update, you know. You drink, if you, like, smoke weed all the time and it's the same strain, it ends up not getting you as high as it usually would, you know. So, it's really good to switch up weeds. So, I do that with a lot of things. whether it's drinks, marijuana, video games, you know, you name it. After a while, I try to switch things up, make it a little bit different, just to get that variety in there, you know. Let's see, I think my camera's in the right place. Everything looks good there. Just about ready with the marijuana. Let's see what Morgana has to tell us real quick. I don't know if I have to go to bed or not. I think this is the evening. I thought I was going to say morning, but it says evening. Wait for contact from Alibaba. Oh, yeah, the freaking hacker lady.
Hey.
First Medjet, now Alibaba. Why are these hackers coming after us all of a sudden? Can I go downstairs?
Hey. Nope.
Okay, yep, we do got to go to sleep. I knew it. Yo, what's up, Luis Barrientos? Thank you for joining us, man. I appreciate it. Luis says, why not Craig's $10 orange juice? Wait, why not Craig's $10 orange juice? Why not Craig? I don't know. I must be missing something, man. I'm sorry. I actually haven't been keeping up with Game Attack's videos lately. I haven't really been watching. So if that's a reference to something recent, man, I completely came over my head. I apologize. I actually was watching their 420 special just a second ago. The one where Bolin and Parker are playing that 420 game. And yeah, that was pretty funny. I don't know. I enjoyed it, I guess. Hadia says, just confirming it's a film. It's called a movie as well. Oh, yes. Movies and films are the same thing, basically. Nowadays, I guess. I mean, before, like in the past, a film would... I mean, people have always called movies films, but film usually was used for, like, photography and stuff like that. And I don't know, since the advent of digital, you know, it's kind of, film kind of doesn't really exist anymore. Film is more of a novelty, it seems like. I mean, professionals still use film in like dark rooms and stuff, but it just depends. But yeah, movies are definitely called films as well. Okay, cool. Got me my banana kush in the pipe, ready to go. Had this for the Donkey Kong stream, but you know, it also works for here, so yeah, this is gonna be some good stuff. Cheers, everybody. Louis says, you're good, man, no worries. Craig loves his $10 orange juice. Man, that's crazy. I didn't even know there was orange juice that was $10. That's crazy. Hey, and we got Asilis Plays in the chat as well. What's up, Asilis? Thank you so much for joining us, man. I appreciate that. Says, yo, and hey, everybody. Hell yeah, dude. Thank you so much for joining. I hope all is well. Let's see. Let's go to sleep here in the game. And yeah, give me a heads up, guys, if anything sounds a little bit off, if the game is a little too quiet or if I'm a little too quiet. But yeah. Yeah, we'll see it. If there's any problems, let me know, and I'll definitely do my best to fix them as soon as possible. Why haven't the Phantom Thieves said anything? Having your money stolen sounds terrifying. You're damn right. It's unsettling not knowing what they're going to do to us. They're declaring their victory. What does that mean? I really wish they'd stop that. Man, I really cannot wait for this boom mic to come in. It's gonna be really nice because I'm not gonna have to keep adjusting my camera and the height of my chair. Cause right now, watch, I'll show you guys real quick. Right now, the way I have my microphone set up, I have it sitting on top of game cases so that it's high enough to hit my mouth. Watch. Let me put you guys in full screen real quick so y'all can see this. One second, I'm gonna have to walk around. Let's see here, how did I have this? One second, guys. All right, there we go. we go. Sorry about that. Making adjustments, making it look real nice and professional. Cool. Take this out of screen. Oh, hey, yo. I just got... Oh, I thought we got a new subscriber, but it was just a like for... I had left a comment on that 420 episode of Game Attack's VOD content. But yeah, here. All right, let's keep it going. Let's see, Esla says, I'm liking this song, though. Song gone. The struggle is real. Yeah, the freaking, the music on this game is amazing, dude. It's some good stuff. Like some light jazz, basically. Really good stuff. Ah, damn it. Hold on 1 second, guys. The wheel on my chair is like hitting my desk, and it's not cool because I can't scoot in as far as I want to. There we go. All right, I apologize. So much unprofessionalism. Hey, your phone's buzzing. Audio says, game audio is a little low, and the word movie still seems strange to me. Don't know why. It's crazy. Let's see. Let's get this game audio up for you guys a little bit. There we go. That should be a little bit better. Let me know if I should turn it up a little bit more or anything. That should be all right, though. A little bit higher than I usually have it, but yeah, not bad. Israel says, do what you got to, my stony brother. Hell yeah, thank you, man. Let's see, did Alibaba message you?
Come on.
Sigh, it's just Ryuji. Nothing? Let us know ASAP if he tries to get in touch with you. I'm going. Hey, we got Brad's dad G in the chat. What's up, man? Pull up a chair, grab a drink, get ready to get stony with us, man. And thank you for joining in. I appreciate it. Take a hit for you for all the newcomers here in a second. Ryuji again? He just never shuts up, does he? Seems like he doesn't. Oh, nope. Not Ryuji this time, buddies. Good day, mate. Who is this? What do you want? Good day to you, too. Ah, you responded today. Once again, I am Alibaba. You are the leader of the Phantom Thieves, correct? Who are you again? I already said I am Alibaba. Oh. I take it you received the calling card, so it really was from this guy. Got the banana kush loaded for you guys today. Some good stuff. Actually smells and tastes a little bit like bananas. Not bad at all. So it really was from this guy. Are you at school right now? Who are you again? I'm in class, yes. You're a surprisingly diligent student. Now then, I have prepared the calling card for you. When are you going to steal it? What? What are you talking about, buddy? Stealing a heart, of course. Aren't you able to steal a heart as long as you have a calling card?
Hey, hey.
Tell him, we need the name of the target. What's the target's name, buddy? A name? Is your heart thievery truly impossible without such information? Just tell me. I see. I suppose past calling cards did have names on them. One moment. Very well, I'll tell you. I believe their name was Fatuba Sakura. If you fail in this mission, I will expose your identity to the world and to the police. Well then, I'll be counting on you. We shall speak again after the change of heart. Who is Fatuba Sakura? Sakura. Maybe Fatuba Sakura. There we go, that sounds right. Who is Futaba Sakura? There we go. There we go. Can't find the account to send a response to. All I get back is an error message. Well, how did we respond this time? So he threatened you, then just took off? And Sakura? I feel like I've heard that name before. In any case, we should let everyone know about this. You're right, Morgana. We should. Hey, Canucks fan, thanks for joining in as well, man. I appreciate it. Hell yeah, lots of G1s jumping in, a lot of stoners coming in today. I appreciate it, guys. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for popping in. Everybody get comfy. Get ready to get stony with us.
Futaba Sakura?
Ah, I was close. It's Fatuba Sakura.
Wasn't Sakura... It's Boss's last name!
Does he have any family?
Boss is his last name. Are they talking about Sohiro?
Does he?
For reals? How laid back are you? Wouldn't you normally be introduced at least? I mean, you are living at his place.
They are talking about Sohiro. No, we can't do that to Sohiro. What the hell?
This situation does make things difficult.
What did Sohiro do? Like, what?
Calling card was delivered to Boss's house. It'd be more natural to assume this is all related.
That's so crazy.
One of the reasons for that is because Alibaba mentioned nothing about which Futaba Sakura.
I can't do that. He's been so nice to us. Knox's fan said, "Hey y'all," and Esla's Play says, "I like when the weed has a fruity flavor. I've had mostly citrus flavors." Yeah, man. Yeah, I definitely enjoy that too. Definitely love that fruity taste more than the earthy taste. And yeah, this banana kush, man, real good, real good.
Perhaps he thinks that the name alone is enough.
Ariel says, Futaba Sakura, without accents, right? Okay, yeah, no worries. See,
that makes sense.
I just want to, like, do it properly in case any, like, Japanese people do end up seeing this stream. They're not offended by the way I pronounce things. Because it's funny when you hear, like, white people try to pronounce Mexican names. Like, a lot of my friends and a lot of my teachers always called me Fernando Montes, but it's Fernando Montes, you know. And then there's so much more than that. Like, mine is barely, like, it's barely an inconvenience when they say it in a different way, you know. But there's a lot of different names that you could say, and it just sounds real funky without that accent on it.
I believe it's adequate for us to think that this is the doing of someone close by.
I see.
I don't know how Alibaba got a hold of his smartphone information. However, since he's ordering us through chat, I do feel as though he's taunting us.
You mean this might just be a prank?
I mean, look at his demands. Pay me if you don't want me to leak who you really are. That I'd understand. But he's telling us to steal someone's heart without explaining why.
So we're being tested.
I don't like being tested. Even in school, I didn't like being tested.
Regardless, I think we should ask Boss about Futaba Sakura once.
That's probably for the best.
Oh, it's probably not Sohiro, but it's like one of Sohiro's...
There's nothing else we can do at the moment.
...family members.
Chief might have an idea on what this is about, too.
Right, okay. Yeah, okay, I see.
I'll check the school's roster, just in case.
See, Azriel says, I'm liking the lemon diesel I got. Oh, yeah, lemon diesel's pretty good. And this list play says, El Pastor, like Al Pastor. But the way other people say it, like non-Mexicans, El Pastor. Yeah, I've heard people say stuff like that as well. Or, like, Asada, like, I've heard people call it Aseda. And then, there's all kinds of stuff. Menudo, like Menudo, Menudo. It's just so funny.
We must make sure Boss doesn't figure out who we are. We'll have to go about this cautiously.
Man, this is getting crazy. What the hell? Why are we going off after Boss's
What's
family?
That?
I want to meet Futaba. Who's Futaba Sakura?
Why do you know about that?
That menu though, Menudo. Right, I guess. List exactly. Some funny stuff.
It's got nothing to do with you. I'm going home. Make sure you lock up the place.
Damn, someone's being secretive, Sohiro.
Looks like it's a hit.
Oh yeah. For shizzle, Morgana. We've got us some dizzle to hizzle. For Rizzle. Oh, I just remembered. Fernando, were you able to ask Boss about Futaba Sakura? 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 Futaba Sakura? Yeah, he didn't want to talk. Could there be a reason as to why that was? Alibaba might be our only hope of defeating Medjet. I wish we could get some info about Futaba out of Boss. but trying to force it out would positively have the opposite effect. To be honest, I owe a great deal to both Boss and Stony. I don't wish for this to be a source of discord between them. Yeah, I know just what you mean. It's probably best to wait for Boss to bring the subject up himself. That's true. Now that we've asked him about it, he's gonna be wondering why, you know, so eventually that curiosity is gonna cause him to be like, hey, why did you ask about this person, you know? And then right there, then and there, you'll be able to naturally get some information. That's the way I'd play it, at least. It doesn't look like making Alibaba talk will be easy. I wonder how we're gonna get the information we need. Oh, guys, earlier today, I went to a sandwich shop called Witch Witch. I don't know if you guys have that out. Out where you guys are at. It's like a better version of Subway, you know, like actual like handmade bread and like fresh ingredients and not like your typical like fast chain your typical chain of fast food restaurants, you know, like which is like really nice, kind of more expensive. And as I was walking in, oh, there was three of the most beautiful blonde girls walking in at the same time. And I wanted to talk to them so bad, but they were just so cute to the point where you're like, nah, there's no way, you know? And now, like, I think back to it, and I'm like, fuck, I should have said something, you know? first there was Medjed, then Alibaba, and now Futaba Sakura? We don't have any info on any of them. What in the world is going on? We gotta go to sleep in order to progress things, right? There's not much else we could do. Going downstairs isn't a possibility because Morgana will be like, hey, you need to sleep. I'd hate a talking cat that tries to control my habits. Yeah. Esla says, ordering beer in Spanish is easy. Yeah, I agree. Uno más, yeah. Azrael says, I'm proud of myself. I can order like 4 beers at a time in Spanish. Oh, hell yeah. I haven't had to order beers in Spanish, but I'm really good at ordering food in general. Like, there's another restaurant called Rico Pollo around here, and they have the best fucking hot wings in Denver. Best hot wings. And every time I call them, I always order the same thing, so they've started recognizing me every time I go in there. Tomorrow's the end of the first semester, but we still got all this lame shit coming up. If you don't take care of this lame shit, you can kiss your summer vacation goodbye. Oh yeah, about this Futaba Sakura girl. God damn it, I don't know why that's such a tongue twister for me. If she's related to Boss, think people living nearby would know about her? There's some keen intuition coming from you, Ryuji. You should have made use of that on your exams. I never want to think about exams ever again. Anyway, asking around in your neighborhood might be the fastest way to figure this shit out. Then again, I doubt it'll be that easy. It never is. That's true. It's very true. Shoot your shot. That's what Liz says. Is that kind of like blow your load? I don't know. I took it too far. I apologize. Summer vacation starts the day after tomorrow, but don't forget, there's an urgent assembly on Monday. We'll be taking attendance. Oh yeah, and another thing, for a little while there, I'm sure you guys noticed that I was drinking these Caribou's like almost every day, but I realized I should probably take it down a notch, and we're only going to be doing this like Thursdays and Fridays, I believe. Maybe just Thursdays, because Thursday is pretty much like my Friday. I always have to get up early on Saturday, so drinking Friday night isn't the best idea for me, so Thursdays are my Fridays. There's an urgent assembly on Monday. We'll be taking attendance. Man, with the 151 and Malibu with orange juice, what was it? Sunny D. Oh my god, dude, it's real good. I don't taste the alcohol at all, and it's delicious. It's almost as good as with the pineapple, you know? But damn. There's been an unusual number of strange incidents this year. Don't do anything stupid over break. Got it. Don't go someplace shady like the red light district, and don't go to the beach after dark. I want to go to the beach. I want to jump in some cold water. Seems like we won't be having fun on our summer break for a while. Well, shit, you guys are phantom thieves. Everything you guys do are fun, I would say. Mm. Ryuji might be right. We don't have a single clue. Might as well try. We've got nothing to lose. Let's head to Yongin and gather info around the neighborhood. Hey, how would you guys feel about, like, to give you guys a little bit of background, I've been trying to find a weed subscription box that sends you, like, a box a month that sends, like, pipes and, like, joint papers and, like, blunt wraps and, you know, all these little accessories, like, hemp rope and stuff like that. If I were to get one and, like, start doing unboxings for, like, some VOD content, would you guys be into something like that? Like, you know, I might even, like, instead of sticking with one every month, we might, like, try a bunch out. And then after I find one that I really like, we'll, like, stick with that one or something, you know? And, I don't know. I feel like that would be something to fun. Something that would be fun. Like, I want to do all kinds of VOD content, but I just, like, every time I go to try to record something, I either don't have the help, of someone else to be able to, like, get creative with me and, like, help me record, or I just don't have the type of, props or ingenuity to, like, do it on my own. So I feel like a subscription box unboxing type thing would be really easy to do. And I'm still working on doing my little highlight video, like, spliced in with me and my parents at the gun range. I want to show you guys how much my AK-47 kicks and how loud it is and stuff, but I haven't been able to really get it to how I like it yet, so I'm still working on that. But it's gonna be a little bit. What am I looking for? I'm sorry, I'm like talking and just going back and forth. Futaba. No, I don't know who that could be. Let's ask some other people too. Okay, we're getting our information on Futaba. Let's see. Azriel says a healthy mission starts with a healthy lifestyle. Oh yeah, definitely. Oh, I'm gonna start being I'm starting going on a diet and start working out really, really hard soon as well. Like, probably within, like, the next week. Because I've been getting too much of a gut lately. Like, I can't even, like, bend over like I used to without, like, feeling really out of shape. Who knows? By the way, do you eat a lot? As I'm talking about going on a diet. Azriel says, I already told you, bro. You make it, I will watch it. Hell yeah, Azriel. I appreciate that. And Canucks fan says, weed box opening thumbs up emoji. Hell yeah, dude. Thank you. So yeah, I'll look into that. Try to get one real soon, and we'll try to work that in somehow. I'll definitely find a way to do it. Audio also says, like Dollar Shave Club, but for weed. Yeah. There's actually quite a few different ones that I didn't really know about. And in California, they actually have a weed box service that sends actual weed in the box, but you gotta be in California for that one. I'm sure Colorado will get one soon, but until then, we gotta go with the regular ones. Essless Play says, dude, you sound like me. I want things to be perfect instead of just releasing content. Right, yeah, I feel you there for sure, because, like, if you're just releasing stuff with no passion in it, you know, like, I just feel like what's the point in that, you know, you gotta... If you yourself don't personally like what you're putting out, how would you expect your subscribers to, you know? So yeah, I definitely want that shit to be as good as possible before you guys see it. if it's just you and him, then you've been eating enough for two, right? You must have quite the appetite. Wow, what a dick. What? You're telling me you don't actually eat that much? Maybe it's Boss who eats a lot then. Let's ask some other people too. weirdo. Futaba? Who's that? I don't know. I don't think I know anybody by that name. But wouldn't this Futaba get angry if they find out you're snooping on them, though? Let's ask some other people, too. Yeah, they probably would be. I wouldn't doubt that. I'd get a little upset if people were going around town asking about me. Futaba? Yes, I know that name. Heard it somewhere before. It's the name of my very first love, my teacher, back when I was in elementary school. Some other people too. What? Okay, Morgana, you could give me some other tips besides let's ask some other people. I was gonna do that either way. Sakura-san's single, right? I thought he didn't have any children. I keep reading Morgana's let's ask other people too. Every single time. No, I don't want to shop. I want to talk to the old man. Whatever.
I can see it.
I can see it too.
We talked to that guy. We talked to that guy. I don't get it either. Who else can we talk to? There's the guy that's inside that shop, but I need to wait for him to come out, or... Oh, here we go. A vintage game console. Could I actually sell it if I threw it in some games? I'm not very sure anyone would buy a game console that's this old, though. We can always come back here later. We need to focus. Okay. Whatever, Morgana. You're so mean. Never letting me do what I want to do.
Focus.
Didn't I ask everybody already? What the heck? Fatuba, who knows? Eat a lot. What are you talking about? Same thing he said last time. Fatuba, is that snooping on him? No. Can I leave? Is there more places I could go besides here? I don't understand. Let's see if we can leave this alleyway. No? Very odd. Fatuba, I know I've heard that name before. Elementary school. Who am I missing? I already talked to this lady. Yeah, I don't get it either. What am I missing here? I talked to this guy. Fatuba, no, don't know who that could be. Maybe I need to give this dude the right thing. No, not really. What, you're telling me you don't need boss? Nope. Weird. This is extremely odd. I've talked to everybody already. Oh, here we go. I didn't see this guy before. Fatuba, nope, don't know anyone like that. I come to Sakurai-san's often to make deliveries, but I've never seen who you're talking about. So, up until now, our biggest lead seems to be boss buys a lot of food, far more than enough for one person living alone. Let's check out all the shops where you can buy food. Okay. Why not? Aria says, a vintage game console. Wonder if it comes with a Super Mario Bros. Game. That sounds cool. That would be dope. I would love to play a little mini game of Mario Bros. Or something inside of this. Hey. The place is so close to LeBlanc. Maybe we'll get something in here. Hey there, welcome. Fatuba, over at Sakurai-san's? I haven't heard anything, sorry. Come again.
That doesn't look like it'll work.
We didn't find anything on Sakurai-san. Or Fatuba. Fatuba. I think our only option now is to go home and ask the chief directly. Alright. He's not gonna like it, but we're gonna do our best, I guess. We're doing it. And oh, hey, it's Makoto's sister.
You read the letter, did you not?
So you're the one who tipped him off about Futaba. You really shouldn't have done that. I have no intention of talking to you about Wakaba.
Futaba, Wakaba. What are these names? What are those?
Back to the matter at hand. Your parental authority will have to be suspended. I take it you're okay with that outcome?
Oh no, that's not good.
What?
Considering the state of your daughter and your family overall, there are no points in your favor.
He has a daughter?
Would you like to take this to domestic court? Our chances of victory are roughly 99.9%, though.
Chance it, Sohiro. She's just trying to intimidate you.
With these suspicions of abuse, there's no way you could avoid having your custody revoked.
Oh.
You're going that far? I told you I don't know a damn thing about it.
We're extremely serious about this. As long as there's a possibility that cognitive science can be linked to psychotic breakdowns.
Fine.
Thank you. I will contact you at a later date.
I doubt you'll find anything you want to hear, though.
That's fine. It will be up to us to decide whether the information you give us is useful or not. Next time I come here, it will just be for a nice cup of coffee.
What the fuck is she doing? She just backed him into a corner, straight made him submit, like a dominatrix. Shut the fuck up, Sohiro. You lost that battle.
That woman is real good at pissing people off. What's with that look? You got something to say?
He knows that we've been hanging out with Makoto, so I wonder if he has a little hate for her. Custody? Court? What was that?
This doesn't involve you.
Is Futaba your daughter?
That's enough! Just behave yourself. Keep going to school if you don't want me to throw you out of here.
Jesus, Oreo, I'm just asking questions, man.
You got that?
Yeah, fuck you.
Lock the store up.
And stay out! After Sohiro leaves.
The existence of this Futaba is for certain. She may be in some kind of bad situation, though. More so, our conjecture that Alibaba is connected to LeBlanc seems to have a pretty solid foundation. Oh, And didn't they mention cognitive something?
Right, yeah, it seems like they're getting into what they're doing.
Chief's hiding.
Right, does Chief know about the metaverse and stuff
really
like that?
We can't press him on the subject, though. Especially after he mentioned throwing you out.
Man, this is getting crazy. Hey, Daddy Gamer 84, what's up, man? Thank you for joining us. Daddy Gamer says, oh, Cachon. What's up, Stony? What's up, Daddy Gamer? Thanks for joining, man. I appreciate that. And that, oh, Cachon. Oh, man, that was some good stuff. That freaking Funky Kong, he's so funky. Man, I gotta keep saying that. Like, that's gotta become like a catchphrase. Just throw, like, freaking make some merch with Okachon on it. I wonder. Damn. Already back to going to sleep? Come on. We just walked around and asked questions. How am I tired? Alright, looks like we gotta go to our assembly at school tomorrow. I guess we won't find answers just by thinking about it. Let's go to bed. Mushi, what's up, Mushi? Thank you for joining. Mushi says, damn, I wanted to be the first. Oh, Cachon. Oh, man, Daddy Gamer beat you to that one, Mushi. But hell yeah, thank you for joining. I appreciate it. Take a hit for you guys for joining in as well. Thank you all so much. I appreciate it big time. You guys are the best.
A woman was threatening Boss?
Still got this banana kush loaded from the Donkey Kong stream, so yeah, that's some good stuff. Focachon.
Yeah. She was going on about domestic abuse and taking the case to court and stuff.
What's up?
Ooh, Makoto it's knows nothing. Something. She knows something.
So to summarize what you told us, Futaba is Boss's daughter. And he's abusing her?
There's two stories, or there's two sides to every story. Don't put words in my mouth, Makoto.
I don't know him very well. Is he really the kind of person who would do that?
I doubt he would. He would be more aggressive towards us if he was like that, you know? Like, no way. Hey, we got Dark Hero 241 in the chat. What's up, Dark Hero? Thank you for joining us, man. I appreciate that. Dark Hero says, hello, everyone. Welcome very much. I don't know what the hell I'm saying anywhere, but welcome. Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. We're playing some Persona 5, dealing with some crazy shit going on. So let's see what we're going to do to get Sohiro out of this. Because I doubt he would abuse his daughter. There's no way.
I would like to believe so as well, but we don't have any conclusive evidence, do we?
Anyone that would abuse their
Is
own children
Alibaba?
Would abuse their, like, their stay in freaking... what would you explain our character as? He's a juvenile delinquent that had to move into another home, so I don't know. Even though we got framed. I've given you a calling card and told you the target's name. You should be ready for this. Why aren't you doing it? I told you I'd help you if you stole her heart. What seems to be the holdup? See, if it's Sohiro that's doing the abusing, why are we taking the daughter's heart? We should be taking Sohiro's heart, right? So it's gotta be the daughter that's doing something wrong. I don't know. I also said I'd report your identity to the police if you didn't help me. Are you okay with that? I'm serious here.
A selfish person.
Well, he does have information on us.
Anyways, this Futaba he's talking about have a palace? If so, need keywords to get in.
Maybe Sohiro?
Try messaging him about him.
Palace? Okay, that I kind of needed to do that just to see if this person was the other one that we saw in the metaverse. But this seems to be someone new, so we'll see. What are you talking about palaces for? This has nothing to do with the conversation. Are you just saying random stuff to dodge Ooh, excuse me, guys. Are you just saying random stuff to dodge the issue?
What are we supposed to do about this? We'd be able to figure out Alibaba's identity if we could just meet with him.
Adia says, your character is a freeloader that has a criminal record. Okay, I could agree with that.
Try asking him if there's any way we could meet up.
Mushi says she used to have roommates like that. LOL. Man. Yeah. Well, no, I haven't really had roommates like that, but I've definitely known people like that. Meet with me? That would be difficult. I have reasons for not being able to go out. That's why I'm contacting you like this.
You can't go out?
Wait, I get it. You steal people's heart directly. That might make things difficult. Extremely difficult. Hold on. I'm thinking. Okay, it's a shame, but I'm calling this deal off. Stop looking into Futaba Sakurai. Or Sakura. I keep saying Sakurai, I don't know why. Forget this ever happened. I won't report you to the police either, don't worry. Sorry for taking your time. Now, if you'll excuse me. Wait a second. I said the deal's off! You're never going to speak again. Or we're going to never speak again. Don't expect me to contact you anymore either. Why are you doing this? I can't find the account to send a response to. All I get is a back error in the message.
Huh? Did what he just shut the whole operation down? This doesn't make any sense.
Right?
Not only can Alibaba not go out, but he won't let us meet Futaba either.
Well, it's none of our business now. We can't contact him anymore.
But what do we do about Medjed? We won't be able to get Alibaba to help us with them now.
Right, that was weird.
Maybe they were just pranking us.
Daddy Gamer says, Sakurai, got Smash Bros on your mind? Right, I think the name Sakurai, just from Nintendo, is probably just getting there instead of Sakura whenever the other name comes up, you know, it's just, it's blocking my speaking skills, I guess.
They made that huge declaration, but they ain't done nothing since. I bet we got him freaked out.
Dark Hero says, haven't seen you in the G1 chat in a while, Stoney. How have you been? I've been doing pretty good, Dark Hero. Thanks for asking, dude. I haven't been keeping up with Game Attack lately. I've just been really busy and focusing on other stuff, you know. I'll probably be up in there sooner or later. I'd commented on their 420 episode, the one that Bolin and Parker did, but besides that, yeah, I haven't been in there for a while, but how you doing, man? Thank you for joining us, I appreciate that.
You mean they backed out because they're afraid we'll change their hearts?
Yep, and now it'd just make them look lame if they came out and apologized.
But...
that doesn't make sense,
Ryuji. I guess with Alibaba and Medjed out of the picture, can we just say this case is closed?
No.
You do have a point. I guess it is safe for us to relax a little.
Makoto, this is coming from you of all people.
Oh yeah, remember Kaneshiro's treasure? Prepare to have your minds blown.
No way, what did you guys
we
get?
We got 150,000 yen out of it.
Damn, that's like $150, right? I know it's not that much, but I don't know how much
that's
exactly
awesome.
That is.
We can really go all out with that kind of money.
Yeah, let's make up for what happened at the fireworks festival. We gotta go eat something fitting for the Phantom Thieves' worldwide debut.
Where would be good?
Ooh, how about sushi? I could really go for some eel too.
I actually don't like sushi.
The best method is to fill yourself on ginger before beginning to eat sushi. That is my master technique.
You don't need to do that this time. Actually, definitely don't do it. I'm all for sushi. You're okay with that too, right?
Any other ideas?
Nope. I want sushi.
Well, fuck you too, Morgana, you cat bastard.
All right, we'll go tomorrow night.
I don't want sushi. I don't like sushi. Well, I mean, I guess I never really tried sushi, so I can't really say. But yeah. I guess I could try it. Audio says 150,000 yen are like $1,500 approximately. You take two zeros out of. Oh, okay. See, so I was close. I said 150. So no, yeah, you're right. 1,500. That seems about right. And Mushi says, Sushi send me with them. I agree with Morgana. Right? Ah, like I said, I've never really tried it. I'm not a big seafood person. I'm not really big on fish. I like crab and lobster with butter and stuff, but I don't know, just fish. Ah, just it's different. It's weird. I would give you guys the real reason, but I probably shouldn't say. I wonder if that Medjed business was just a prank. Now that I think about it calmly, it's strange that they haven't actually done anything yet. If their goal is to target the Phantom Thieves, they should want to be acting now, given our fame. Huh? When you put it that way, it kind of makes me wonder too. Especially after they taunted us theoretically like that. How did they theoretically taunt you? Yes, however, it would be best for us to come up with countermeasures regardless. For now, though, we should continuously enjoy the sushi. That is all we can do. Something's not right, guys. I don't like this. I was thinking that, too. I can't really put it into words, though. Yusuke is right. I'm sorry for bringing this up on the day before our celebration party, too. Cheer up, Makoto. We'll be eating sushi like kings tomorrow. I hope one person in particular is on their best behavior. I'll refrain from saying who, though. You better not be talking about me. Freaking Ryuji, I swear. I like how these how this game gives these guys so much character, you know? Like, I try to put a different spin on all their voices and stuff just to give them a little bit of a different difference, you know? Like, so that you guys can tell that different people are talking, you know? But, yeah, I like the way I see it. There's a lot of depth to each of them, and, like, I like it. It's crazy. Do you think Alibaba calling off our deal has anything to do with the chief? It's so hard to tell what the truth of the situation is. I'm guessing it's time for bed?
Hey!
God damn it, Morgana. We have a party at the sushi shop tomorrow. You know? Let's call it a day and go to sleep. I guess. God damn it. I'm more of a night owl. Let's call it a day and go to bed. Let's go to bed. Lucia says, we had our first summer-like thunderstorm today. It was nice. It's gone now, though. Feels great out. Have the patio door open. So relaxing. Ooh, I love days like that, Mushi, where you're able to just turn off the
seem quite busy,
so AC and just chill.
Ooh. I take it you're stuck in the middle of everything?
The Phantom Thieves made a mockery of us when they brought down Kaneshiro. And to make matters worse, Medjed, who has been dormant for some time now, just declared war on them. How much more can they screw us over?
Stress is bad for the skin, you know.
And the heart.
Did you come all this way simply to be sarcastic?
Kichi.
How about you listen to my deductions for a change of pace? You may think it absurd, but don't you think the case you're pursuing and the actions of the Phantom Thieves overlap somehow?
So that would make them good people, right?
What are you basing this off of?
The one point of commonality across all cases is how those involved have an unforeseen change of heart.
I've suspected that myself, but those suspicions are unfounded.
I told you at the beginning that this was only a deduction. These just Phantom Thieves are riling up the public. However, that is a disguise. Their true goal is terrorist action by way of psychotic breakdowns. Is that too much?
There's nothing at the moment that falsifies that claim. Have you mentioned this to the police?
I'd never tell them such things. The only value they have to me is in their mobility and organizational capabilities.
Isn't she part of the police, though?
It seems having you lend me a hand has paid off.
I'm glad to hear that. What about your case, Sai-san?
Sai-san.
Did you learn anything from the guardian of that mental shutdown victim's daughter?
See, Ariel says, I just tried rice rolls and didn't like it, but not all sushi. Also, theoretically, is like it's dramatic if like it was a part of a tether play. Yeah, no, I'm just messing around. Yeah, I get you though. I was thinking like theoretically, like in theory that they, like it was only a theory that they mocked them, you know. But you know, yeah, no, I get you. I get you.
Nothing at all.
I see. Now, what should my next action be for our victory?
Mushi says, lots of good kinds. I know raw sushi isn't for everyone. Yeah, I definitely know how that is. If any sushi I were to try, it would be cooked, definitely. Like raw sushi, I don't know. I just don't think I would like it, honestly. I've never really liked fish cooked or not cooked. I like fishing, but I don't really like touching the fish, you know, and just the smell always gets to me. I don't know, it's just weird.
Handle the Phantom Thieves without remorse. Use any means necessary to win. That's how I would deal with them.
Daddy Gamer says, if I could find some veggie-only sushi, that'd be okay. Yeah, I could probably go with that as well.
Very well.
I really like soy sauce, so like soy sauce and rice, or like, sweet and sour sauce as well. Ooh, that's always some good stuff.
This seems to be fun for you. Are you on to something?
No, not at all.
Oh, okay. Arias says Sei is a prosecutor, belongs to the court rather than the police. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. She's more of a legal defendant, basically.
Well then, to our victory.
I get it now. Okay, I thought she was more of a detective, so okay. I see. She's like getting information for the cases that are like upcoming and stuff. Okay. I get you. Daddy Gamer says, speaking my language, Stoney. Hell yeah, I get you for sure, Daddy Gamer. This place is in Ginza, right? Do we take the usual train from Shibuya? Ginza. Ooh, we unlocked another area in our map. Hell yeah. Dude, this is opening up more and more. I never think about how much more this map can actually open up, but damn.
All right.
I can't wait to like see it at the end of the game where all these branches out, like all these city areas are branching out and you can just go back and forth. Oh, dude, it's going to be cool. It's going to be real good. Mushi says, try some cooked crab or shrimp sushi someday. Ooh, you know what? I do love shrimp, though. Shrimp and butter. Like, any...
Flounder is out of this world.
Seems like anything with butter is really good. Like, I love crab. I love crab. I love lobster. And I love shrimp in butter, though. Like, as long as it's with butter, oh, it's the best. It's like, salt and butter, oh, it's so good. It's probably unhealthy the way I eat it, but it's so good.
I don't see any prices listed here.
It's called market price. Don't worry about it, we got the cash.
Canucks fan says, fish and chips for me, or blackened halibut with mango salsa has been the only seafood I truly like. Mm. That actually sounds really good, but, man, yeah, I don't know, like I said, the smell and stuff. I mean, I'm sure if I tried different ways of, like, seasoned fish where it tastes different and stuff like that, I'm sure I'd like, but just, I've never really explored it, you know, never really tried it.
So good!
But the way these guys make it sound.
Hey, is the fatty tuna ready yet?
Your horses and don't talk.
Tuna especially. I really do not like tuna.
By the way,
Stoney-kun,
is Boss really the kind of person who would abuse someone?
Mushi says, haha, that's the American way, ain't it? Butter. Heart emoji.
That again?
I can't get it off my mind. Especially if it means he could be taken to court. What kind of person is he? Do you truly believe he'd do such a thing?
No way. Sohiro is really awesome. Like, I feel like there's no way he would. Like, he might be a tight ass and stuff like that, but I doubt he would, like, hit his... I doubt he would physically abuse his wife or daughter or whoever this person is to him.
If it's really true about the abuse, he'd be a no-good jerk pretending to be a guardian.
See, there's no way.
Maybe the chief is the one who needs a change of heart.
Daddy Gamer says, fatty tuna sounds like a strain of weed. I would not doubt it, honestly.
Hold on a sec. About that.
Can I get a fatty or some fatty tuna?
I actually got curious after our conversation and checked his name in the nav.
Sounds to me like there wasn't a hit.
Right. Anything beyond this is his family's problem. We probably shouldn't get any more involved.
Weird.
Wait, you think Alibaba could be Boss's ex-wife?
See, maybe. Like I said, it could be someone other than his daughter.
He must have cheated on her, and that's where Futaba came from.
I don't know what.
Doubtful.
Your imagination has run rampant.
How foolish.
At least he's trying to think, guys.
Still, this is delicious. I've never experienced anything quite like it before.
Ah, someone's a virgin.
Man, and it's all thanks to us being the Phantom Thieves.
I'm just kidding. Oh, you fucking idiot. You stupid idiot.
Fan...
What a fucking idiot.
Fantastic! This sushi is delicious!
And then all of them just get off wide-eyed and, oh.
Yeah! The fish is so fresh. Everywhere we go, we hear about these Phantom Thieves.
What rubbish.
No way. You fucking idiot,
Think
Ryuji.
Think about where we are, Ryuji.
Sorry, it just kind of slipped.
You fucking idiot, Ryuji. Mushi says, I'm totally ordering sushi later. And Jeebus, this game is triggering for my appetite. Oh yeah, I know how that is. They make everything look good.
My apologies for bringing up Boss again. We should just enjoy the food.
Canucks fan says, ouch, that's no good. Not sure if it will help out, but any stomach issue, I just drink some apple cider vinegar and water. Apple cider vinegar and water. Yeah, definitely. I really find 7-Up to be really good for, like, stomach problems. And every time I drink a 7-Up, whenever my tumbly is rumbly, it definitely always helps. So, yeah, definitely look into that.
Ijima-san.
Oh,
Akichi,
what's up? What's up, homie?
Akechi-kun.
Ooh, she's caught.
Akechi? You're the ones from the TV station. Could it be that you're friends of Nijima-san?
Azriel says, Monster Hunter World had better presentation of the mills. Oh, fuck yeah, I could agree with that for sure, man. Every time I saw those fucking cats cook a mill or your helper cook a mill, oh my god, my mouth watered every time.
Do you know this guy?
It's nice to meet you. My name is Akechi. Glad to make your acquaintance, Yusuke Kitagawa.
Akechi's been looking into somebody.
How do you know my name?
Oh, well, he is kind of famous, though.
Well, because I'm a psychic, of course. I'm only joking. In truth, I'm a rookie detective. You're a former pupil of Madarame, right? I have actually just recently joined the investigation team looking into the Phantom Thieves.
Huh.
Did you see that Mejed has declared war on them?
Yeah, we did, homie. What's
war?
Up?
Their
oh,
website
wait, no, we
was
didn't
updated
see that.
Just a moment ago.
Uh-oh.
For real? Ah, English again!
Mushi says, oh yes, I like 7-Up, Sprite, Sierra Mist, Ginger Ale. Those are good to go on tummy things, right? Yeah, definitely. I agree with that for sure.
Wait, what?
What's it say?
No way, what's going on?
Why do you seem so agitated?
Akechi, get the fuck away from us, dude.
She's a huge fan of the Phantom Thieves. A total nutjob for him. I don't know how wise it is to be a fan of groups like them.
What is with these comments?
My apologies. I didn't mean to butt into your conversation, but I must say, this is an interesting group.
Huh.
Prosecutor Nijima's sister, an ex-pupil of Madarame, and a few Shujin Academy students.
Right, all of them have a connection to the Phantom Thieves.
It seems you're all connected to the Phantom Thieves. Perhaps
right?
You have better intel than I do.
Wow.
Ah, yes. I wanted to ask you something. Regarding this whole Mejed commotion, if you were one of the Phantom Thieves, what would you do?
Oh, hell no. I don't care. Get him away.
Unsurprising. I suppose you aren't interested in such gossip.
Sorry to disappoint, but we're just normal high school kids. If anything, we want to hear what you gotta say, Mr. Detective.
Right? My profiling of the Phantom Thieves has led me to believe they are a group of juveniles. They have a relative amount of free time after school and a hideout to slip away to.
Oh, sure.
Furthermore, considering Kamoshida was their first target, it seems they began activity around April.
He's dead on.
In a way, all I've just said about the Phantom Thieves coincides with the group you have here.
Oh, hell no. Right, he's
what?
Getting close to
you gonna
it.
You gonna report us? I didn't say I was being suspicious of you.
Ryuji's a Phantom Thief. Oh man, that'd be so funny to say.
I wasn't anticipating that response. You always find a way to rise above my expectations. You really are an intriguing one. I lack your calm mannerisms, but don't you think my deduction is an interesting one?
Sure.
I bet we'd make a great team if we worked together.
What?
Weird.
What the hell are you saying?
Right, this is a
little
weird.
I'm curious to hear what you have to say. You seem to be a wealth of information. In return, I'll teach you how to make deductions.
Oh, do we have us a new,
I believe that is a fair trade-off for you.
Interesting. Oh, it is. Oh, shit, what do you know? That's crazy. A new confidant, that's what I'm looking for. La Justice. L.A. Justice. Dark Hero says, I just drank a shot of white vinegar on a dare. It was a bad idea. Ooh, man, that's not bueno. Ugh, that's horrible. I cannot take the smell of vinegar either. That's sad. That's the worst. Mushi says, I have it, but would rather not swig white vinegar, right? Ugh. Mushi says, apparently apple cider vinegar is good to help lose weight and keep blood sugar regulation in balance and bodily function. Hmm. That's crazy. I didn't know that. That's way crazy. Mushi
well,
puts hashtag law justice.
A point of reference for me.
That was a little weird.
What was that about?
Right. I feel like Akichi's onto us.
You think he's ascertained our true identities?
Nah, but he's getting there.
Nah, couldn't be. Right?
I almost had the same reaction as Ryuji.
I'd like to say that it's simply us overthinking this, but maybe best to be cautious from now on.
Right. Like, the way you guys are hanging out, the way things have been coincidentally happening, like, yeah.
We shouldn't forget that Alibaba was able to discover who we are.
It's a little obvious.
True, but it's not as though he had tangible evidence to prove that discovery.
Does Ryuji have a weed leaf on his belt buckle? Like, that kind of looks like a weed leaf belt buckle, doesn't it? I don't know, I can't really tell, but it kind of seems like it.
Just keep acting normally.
More importantly, things are getting serious with Medjet.
Right?
Oh yeah! What did they write?
I forgot about that too.
Here, I'll read it. We are disappointed in the people of Japan and their belief in the Phantom Thieves' false justice.
Yeah, fuck you too, Medvet.
Hence, we shall proceed with our plan to cleanse Japan. This process will commence on August 21st.
What?
As a result, the Japanese economy shall suffer devastating damages.
For real?
That doesn't sound good. Mushi asks, what does dude's yellow shirt say? I'm not too sure. It says like Oon Oon Mark or something like that.
Keep going.
Mushi says, I just see Mark. I'm pretty sure it just says On Oon, like O-N-U-N, something
However,
like that.
We are magnanimous. We will give the Phantom Thieves one final opportunity to repent.
Audio says, doubt it, probably just a buckle. Right, I'm not too, yeah. I don't know, like it has like a little bit of an outline of a green something on it, but yeah, you're probably right.
As proof of this repentance, we demand that they reveal their identities to the public. We will attack if these demands remain unmet. The future of Japan rests with the Phantom Thieves.
Oh, wow.
We are Medjed, we are unseen, we will eliminate evil.
How does destroying Japan's economy eliminate evil?
That's what it says.
Wow. That's crazy.
Sounds bad.
That's real fucked up.
In other words, if we don't unmask ourselves, Medjed will attack Japan, correct? it seems they are quite the attention seekers.
Ariel's right. It says on your mark. Yeah, okay. That makes sense. Cause he used to be in the school's track team.
What are we gonna do about this?
If only we could get in contact with Alibaba.
Our only clues are Boss and Futaba.
But she says, oh, I wanted it to be, oh, hi, Mark.
Anyways, that'd be so funny. Out here. Why don't we go to LeBlanc and talk more over there?
Oh, hi, Mark. That would be perfect. Oh, man, that'd be so hilarious.
We went through all sorts of options on our way here, but...
I'm gonna make another drink as these guys are talking. I'm gonna keep pressing buttons, though. I'll be listening.
Looks like we got no choice but to ask for Alibaba's help.
Question is, how do we get in touch with him?
He cut off all contact with us after that misunderstanding. Then again, if we manage to steal Futaba's heart, he may attempt to reach out to us once more.
But we don't have any clues on what her keywords are.
Damn it, Alibaba! Where the hell are you?
Actually, he may be closer than we think. Hypothetically speaking, even if we stole Futaba's heart, how would Alibaba know that the deed has been done? Would he truly be able to discern that just from cell phone messages? You mean he'd have to meet her in person? Alibaba was able to deliver the calling card here. On top of that, he can check on Futaba's condition. However, according to the circumstances he put forth, he's unable to meet with us. This leads me to believe that it would be bad for him if we were to see the two of them together. It seems to me Alibaba may in fact be Futaba herself.
For real?
So she's asking that we steal her own heart?
Maybe she wants us to save her from the scars of her abuse. That would be hard to ask directly.
I'd like to meet with Boss. He lives nearby, right?
I agree. It's real late, though. What are we gonna tell Boss when we get there?
We'll say this takeout sushi is a gift for him.
But my fatty tuna!
No complaining.
Let's all go together.
My fatty tuna! That had to have been the funniest thing I've heard today.
Boss may get the wrong idea if he and I show up alone.
Azrael says, Anchan, what are we going to do? Me, smoke weed. Right? Mushi says, Alibaba is from Spirited Away. Right? Ariel says, you should really stop making drinks during important story points. You never know what could happen. You can pause the game and then we don't mind waiting. Yeah, no worries. I mean, I was listening to the whole thing. I was paying attention. And then whenever, like, something popped up for me to choose, I'd run up and look at the screen to make sure I chose which one would be correct, you know. And, yeah, I'm still paying attention and stuff. But, yeah, next time I could definitely pause it.
Come on.
Think he's napping? Oh, I thought they were going to start talking themselves for some reason. Even Boss would have woken up with how many times we've rung this doorbell. I would think Futaba would have answered by now if she were here too. Mushi says, no, not my fatty tuna. Bitch slap. And I figure you had the headset on, dude. Yeah, I usually take this thing wherever I go. Take this thing with me wherever I go. Whenever I'm streaming or playing video games. Dude, you can't go opening other people's stuff like that.
Hey.
But look, the door seems to be slightly open as well. I wonder why. That's rather careless. Whoa. Sounds like it's going to rain. We should get inside. Do you think that's okay? Probably. My apologies, boss. Ooh, I don't know about that, man. He'd probably get pissed. I'd get pissed. If a bunch of kids just came into my house thinking that they were invited.
Hello?
In, like,
sir?
A little upset. But I guess we're going to see what's happening, because why would
he's
leave his door
out,
open?
Is he? The door ahead is open, and I can hear the TV.
Don't tell me Sohito's hurt. Don't tell me he's,
hope
like,
he didn't
dead
pass
or something.
Out or something. I mean, boss is kind of old, ain't he?
Arias, that's just in case you need to see something rather than listen happens. Okay, yeah, no worries. I'll definitely, next time we could pass it.
I'm a bit worried. Should we go in and check on him?
Please excuse us.
Makoto. Oh, God. Don't be dead, boss. Please don't be dead. What's going on here?
Scream? What was that?
That wasn't on. I thought it was on.
How should I know?
Did you hear that?
Let's get out of here, please. Can we just go?
Sohiro's not an abuser. Come on.
Are you freaking
There's
out
no
for?
Way. What's going on here?
I'm not freaking out.
What if
Alibaba?
Yeah, Futaba.
I mean, Futaba?
What if Futaba is the one that's, like, abusing Sohiro or something? I don't know.
Sorry, can I hold your hand?
He's like, no. keeps his hands in his pocket.
I can sense someone's presence.
Yusuke, you're not psychic. Shut the fuck up.
Who is it? Who's there? I can't take this anymore. I'm leaving. No. My legs won't move.
Uh-oh. Oh, it's her. No way. No way, that's Futaba.
Alibaba! Futaba! Hey, come on, where are you?
That's gotta be Futaba.
You're a hacker, right? Just show yourself!
Dude, this is getting crazy.
I'm sorry, please save me, sis!
Daddy Gamer says, jinkies! Mushi says, Karabulu, give us strength, right?
Are you okay, Futaba?
Oh, it is Futaba. Ooh, what the fuck?
Crap, he's home!
And Sohiro's here. Uh-oh.
Who the hell are you? Don't move! You hear me?
I'm sorry, I'm so sorry, sis! Somebody please save me!
fucking Makoto. Getting all scared.
You? What are you doing in my house?
That'd be a little odd to see him for so, you know, thinking I'm a pimp or something.
You're...
Oh, good evening, sir. We...
Nijima-san. Wait, are you two dating?
We're just friends.
friends nowadays get that close to each other?
That's not it! This, things happened, and...
you're not making anything any clearer, Makoto.
You kids are here too?
We brought you some sushi, but nobody answered when we rang the bell. The door was unlocked too. We could hear the TV though, so we got worried you might have passed out or something.
The door was unlocked.
Yes.
I do that sometimes. Because I'm getting old.
Excuse me. There's something we'd like to ask.
You want to ask me?
There's someone else living here. Isn't there?
Yeah.
Daddy Gamer says, "You meddling kids and your stupid cat." And Mushi says, "Kitty seems to be perfectly fine with all this, right?"
Yeah. My daughter.
Freaking, it seemed like the cat didn't care at all.
Could she be
Morgana?
Utapa Sakura?
You told Nijima-san too?
Is there any way we could meet with Futaba-san? I think we may have frightened her earlier, so we'd like to apologize if at all possible.
Well, that's...
Is she sick?
No, it's not like that.
Come on, Chief, just tell us.
I don't want you getting the wrong idea. I shouldn't have kept this a secret from you. Let's talk at my shop. She'll hear us if we stay here.
Huh. What the hell is Sohiro gonna unveil on us now? What is going on here? I'm so confuzzled.
Now, where do I start? Futaba's mother and I knew each other long before Futaba was born. Her mother was a bit of a weird one, but we got along well for some reason. She was sharp-witted, somewhat stern, a little socially inept, but always carefree. She truly was a great woman.
I see.
When something piqued her interest, that'd be all she focused on. She always worked deep into the night.
Like a prostitute.
I thought that'd change after her kid was born. But having Futaba didn't do much.
Oh, I like this song too. This song is really good whenever it plays.
Even with that, she always took good care of her.
Working and watching over a child at the same time sounds rough.
I guess raising Futaba alone turned out to be tough on her in more ways than one.
Alone? Yeah, well, what about her father? What about you, Sohiro?
There wasn't a father.
Oh.
Do you mean...
You're her stepfather?
Well, there probably was one. I didn't know him, though. She never said a word about him, either. She was single when she gave birth to Futaba, and single when she raised her. They were an ordinary, loving family. You could really tell how much she cared for Futaba. But one day, she left, leaving Futaba behind.
What? She left? She didn't die, did she?
Yes.
Oh,
she committed suicide.
That's fucked up.
Suicide?
Damn.
Threw herself into the street, right in front of Futaba's eyes.
Damn.
Shocking doesn't begin to describe that.
Right, damn, that's fucked up.
It's gotta be devastating for a kid.
That's fucked up.
So, well, a lot happened after that, but I ended up taking custody of Futaba.
Why did she want us to change her heart,
first,
though?
First, she was so depressed, she wouldn't even talk to me.
Was that because she couldn't get over her mother's suicide?
Bring it up again on this girl.
I kept talking to her, though, and she started opening up to me, little by little.
Damn.
That's when I found out.
Mushi says, this reminds me of soap operas on TV years ago. Right, I get that. And it turns out he's the real dad's twin.
Futaba blames herself for her mother's death.
Oh, man.
What?
That's why she wants us to change her heart.
That part she's never told me. I wanted to know what led her to believing that. But I decided not to rub salt in the wound. Then, a few months ago...
Oops. Wrong button.
She started getting real scared. Even when nothing was happening, she'd say things like, I hear voices and Mom is looking at me.
Visual and auditory hallucinations. Have you taken Futaba to a doctor?
I wanted to, but she refused. Even when I had a doctor come, she locked herself away in her room. Since then, she's become what you'd call a shut-in.
Uh-oh.
She won't take a single step outside the house. Or even try to see other people.
Man, I really don't know how someone could do that. Like, I live by myself and stuff. I've got my dog, but I have to leave at least once and, like, interact with other people. As much as an introvert as I am, I cannot just be by myself all the damn time, you know?
What about you?
Mushi says, bring the lady doctor. And Adiala says, still pretty sad, right? Yeah, that's crazy.
She doesn't even let me come in her room.
Mushi says from earlier, who helped the girl?
That's pretty harsh.
Not too sure.
Futaba is, well, a unique girl.
She's the hacker girl that we saw too. I recognized her.
She's so quick-minded that conversations with her tend to jump from one topic to the next.
So she's got to be Alibaba.
It seems like she's always coming to conclusions in her head. There's a lot I don't get about her. So, yeah. Her situation is why I couldn't let you in my house.
I understand.
What Futaba needs is a safe place where nobody will threaten her. Somewhere she can be at ease.
She can be part of our group.
That's why I won't do anything she doesn't want. I don't make her do anything she's unwilling to either.
So, wait, why is Makoto's sister going after you then, Sohiro?
And again, I know that's no way for her to live. It's all I can do, though.
Like, why is Soe attacking him? Why did she come and threaten him?
I don't know. She just asks me for things that she wants, like food or these complicated books.
There's still unanswered questions.
Well, that's that.
Would Makoto know anything about... Nah, it seems like she's just in as much in the dark as us.
So, can you just leave her be? I'm gonna head back then.
I'm sorry, Sohiro.
You all had better head home soon, too.
Right, it's almost curfew, guys. Love enthralling myself into the games like that.
I feel awful for prying into his personal affairs.
Right?
No way in hell he's abusing her.
Like, when you hear me say things back to these guys, this is how I would act in, like, a normal situation, like if I was talking to normal people, like regular people, real
people. The reason why Futaba wants her heart stolen must be related to what happened to her mother.
So she'd like to discard her feelings of pain, but can't do anything about it herself.
Yeah, but us stealing her heart wouldn't really do much, right?
Will changing her heart really help her, though?
See, An's on the same track.
If we can help her, we may be able to stand up to Medved.
Everybody said go to Medved. It's possible. It's possible.
Hold on a sec. Do we even know if she has a palace?
But... Wait, what are you guys gonna try to do?
The Futaba Sakura that lives at Sojiro Sakura's house. Is that gonna be enough?
Candidate found.
Wow. That was easy.
She's got one.
So someone can have a palace even if they're not evil? Hey, Morgana. Where's Morgana?
I haven't seen him for some time.
Uh-oh.
So, ever since we went inside Boss's house?
Morgana just chilled. She's getting intel. Or he's getting
somewhere
intel.
Around there. He'll be fine, though. He's a cat, after all. The trains are gonna be shutting down for the night soon, so we should probably be heading home.
Trains in Japan don't go 24/7? That's crazy.
We have to go to school in the morning after all.
Don't buses go 24/7? I don't know. I've never really rode the bus.
Oh, right. The urgent assembly.
Mochi says, during stressful times, you know, drink tea or coffee or... tea or coffee, yeah. And then Mushi says, someone needs manners. Bring me my fatty tuna back.
An assembly? What about?
Shujin has been garnering a lot of attention ever since Medved called out the Phantom Thieves.
Damn you, Medved.
So they need to remind us not to say arbitrary stuff online and add more fuel to the fire.
Everybody said go to Medved.
We gotta meet up for every goddamn little thing. Talk about a pain in the ass.
I mean, it is our fault.
Anyway, let's contact each other afterward.
Man, this is crazy. I still have questions to ask Soyuro.
No way in hell he's abusing her.
Oh. See, I told you. She's Alibaba.
The reason why Futaba wants her heart stolen must be related to what happened to her mother.
Yeah, just bring it up again on. Fucking asshole.
So she'd like to discard her feelings of pain, but can't do anything about it herself.
Audio says, subways stop after a certain hour. I think it's like that everywhere. Huh. I did not know that. There's a train station here in Denver called the Denver Light Rail or whatever, and I think it goes 24 hours. I'm not too sure. But, like I said, I've never really rode them, so I really don't know, honestly.
Will changing her heart really help her, though?
If we can help her, we may be able to stand up to Medved. Hold on a sec. Do we even know if she has a palace?
Yes.
Let's check. The Futaba Sakura that lives at Sojiro Sakura's house. Is that gonna be enough?
What the?
She's got one.
So someone can have a palace even if they're not evil? Hey, Morgana.
Yep. Morgana got all that intel. Oh yeah, told you. He's the master thief. Moshi says, I only rode buses and light rails. Yes, that's what it is. Denver has a light rail. That's what it is. Morgana's gotta be coming back, right? Without Morgana, Morgana isn't back yet. I wonder if he'll eventually come back if I wait for him. Damn you, Stony! Morgana's gone. You could do whatever you want now, damn it. No Morgana to tell you to go to bed. Adios says, Futaba is listening to what you just experienced yourself. Yeah. No, I got that. Morgana was there and able to, like, realize what's going on, realizing that we're getting tracked by Futaba, you know? So, yeah, I got that whole section there. No worries. I just, without Morgana here, I thought I'd have a little bit more freedom, but no. Mushi says, should have saved the sushi. I'd share with Morgana. That old TV, though, Mushi says, right?
Hey,
what's up, Morgana? I knew you'd be back. We kind of threw your tuna out, though. Were you just going to go to sleep without even wondering where I was? I take it that Chief told you about Futaba and that you guys disbanded the relief for now. How do you know that? You can't underestimate my intel gathering skills, you know. I was checking out the chief's house. I didn't think our Alibaba would be so young. Young? Well, she's probably about the same age as you guys. At least her voice was pretty young sounding. Oh, and she had long hair too. At the very least, she's surely no amateur. She completely overheard your conversation with the chief, and she can hack into our chats too. Even if she can't take Medved down directly, she might have some kind of lead on them. Just who is she? In any case, we'll need to rely on Futaba to get closer to Medved.
Okay.
Let's meet up again tomorrow. How about we do it in here? It's way too hot outside. Anyway, make sure you let everyone know. Ooh. I know about the heat outside. My dog was really he didn't want to go and actually walk a longer walk like I usually would take him, you know. He wanted to take the shortcuts that we take to make it home quicker today, because it was so fucking warm today. So warm. It's been the warmest it's been all freaking year. And it's nice. It's getting really nice. I'm able to walk outside without a jacket and with shorts on. And, like, you know, I'm able to go for a run in, like, some breathable gear, you know. So I'm ready to do a diet and, like, start exercising really hard, you know. I'm going to get on it. I'm going to get on it real good.
Futaba Sakura? She had one of these palaces?
Mushi says, can play Duck Hunt on it. Right? Yeah, those old SRT TVs. Yeah, freaking without those, you can't play Duck Hunt on it. The freaking gun doesn't work on the newer TVs for some reason. That's really weird to me because, you know, it's the same thing, you know. It's like the flash and then one part is white. If the freaking gun sees it, like, how will it not see it on a flash? I don't know. I don't get it. I really don't get it. But, yeah. You can only have those old CRTVs to be able to play Duck Hunt and, like, all those old gun games. It's crazy. It's really weird.
Hold on. While Medjid was targeting you, you chose to deal with someone completely unrelated to them?
Well, duh. She was a hacker. We needed her. That's right, bitch. Are you surprised? They were an unseen enemy. I'm gonna go with that's right, bitch.
Then how was Medjid...
Mushi says, yes, these new ones won't work, right? Yeah, it's weird. It's really weird.
What you said about the Sakura family generally falls in line with our investigation. It appears you aren't feeding us a false testimony.
It's really cool, though, that I have, like, a computer monitor and I'm actually able to play my PlayStation on it, though, with, like, HDMI, you know? It's like having my TV here, but it's a lot clearer and a little bit smaller, you know? It's perfect for what I need, you know? I had, like, a 48-inch TV on my desk here, and it was really big being, like, this close to it, you know? It was really too big for how close I was. But now that I've got this Samsung monitor, it's only about, like, 28 inches or something like that. And it looks really nice, you know. It's the perfect size. I'm not, like, getting blinded by it. It's really nice. It's really good. And as soon as I get my boom stand for my microphone, it's gonna be like 10 times better. Like, all of this is, like, so professional. Like, it does not make sense for me not to do this, you know. Like, I've put so much money into it. I put so much time and effort into it. Like, if I stopped, like, there's no fucking point. There's no point. Like, I'd be wasting money if I stopped, you know? Like, it's crazy. It appears you aren't feeling... I'm not lying to you.
You have quite the wit. Very well. Let's continue.
Mush says, oh, you got it from your folks. What do you mean? What did I get from my folks? I'm not too sure what you're talking about, Mushi.
We've yet to determine how the Phantom Thieves dealt with Medjid, seeing as they are unseen.
Oh, the monitor. Yeah, my dad bought me the monitor. He bought it for me because, he really believes in me being able to, you know, successfully do the YouTube thing. Like I've told him about all the subscribers and all the help that you guys give me, you know, and he thinks that it might actually turn out into something. My mom, not so much, but my dad, he's really, really helpful and really, he helps inspire me to do more than what I think I could do, you know. Like, he's a very, I look up to him quite a bit, for sure.
If you tell me something coherent, I may be a little more willing to believe you.
Seems Sainajima is starting to seriously listen to what I have to say. Oh, now she's believing us. Mushi says, hashtag Stoney's dad's a great dad. Oh, yeah. My dad's the best dad ever, for sure. For sure, for sure. Like, my dad, the only reason he lives is to make sure his kids have a better life than what he does. Like, no matter what. Like, he's the best. He's the best. My dad is definitely... the best dad I've ever known. Like, out of all my friends, out of anybody I've ever known personally, my dad has always been better right. than anybody's dad. Like, he's always been very, very helpful, very inspiring, very, you know, like, he does his best to make sure, like I said a second ago, he does his best to make sure we have a better life than he ever had, you know, and he's doing a very, very good job.
Still, to think the Phantom Thieves would have their hideout in the home of Wakaba Ishiki's daughter.
Daddy Gamer says, that's awesome, he's so supportive. Oh yeah, for sure, man, I love it. My dad is the best. Aria says, he is great. You'll change your mom's heart at some point. Yeah, like, it's not like she doesn't believe in it. It's just that she's a little skeptical for now, you know. She's like, it could go one way or another, you know. That's how it is for anybody, though. And I can see her point of view as well, you know. Like, she doesn't think that it's going to completely fail or that it's a negative thing or anything like that. It's just she doesn't see the positives like my dad does.
No. And,
like, she'll
perhaps
still...
it's fate.
She'll still help me out with, like, purchases and stuff like that. Like, the desk that I have, her and my dad helped help me buy for it as well. Or help me buy it as well. But, yeah, my dad, he'll go out of his way to to buy me some of the things that I need. Just 'cause he feels like I'm an entrepreneur just like him. And I feel the same way. I feel like I could do him very proud, very proud.
Regardless, we don't have time to waste. Continue with your story.
Mushi says, I still want to hear him play and sing someday. I'm going to be going down there this Saturday, Mushi, and I'm going to do my best to get him on that karaoke machine. I'll get a recording for you guys, I promise. I promise. Mushi says, my mom said the same, and that kids come first, right? I feel the same way. Whenever I have kids, I'm going to do the same thing. Be the same way my dad's been with us. Like, no matter what, I've never been, like, second hand to him, you know? I've never been, like to him, I'm not the kid that, only calls when I need
Seriously?
Something, you know? Like, if something happens and, like, if I were to go to jail, my dad's the type of guy to go and pay the bail and pick me up as soon as he knows I'm in there. Like, no joke, I did have a bunch of traffic tickets a while ago, and one of them I had moved after I got the ticket and didn't get it in my proper mailbox because I didn't let the DMV know that I moved. And it was completely my fault, stuff like that, you know. I didn't pay the ticket, so I was asked to go to court, and I didn't make it to court, so I had to turn myself in to the Denver police, and I ended up spending the night in jail. And before that happened, my dad, he took me from my hometown of Leadville, he took me from there 120 miles to the Denver police, or no, it wasn't Denver, it was Jefferson County Police Department. And my dad, as soon as I turned myself in, my dad stayed there the same amount of time as I did. He stayed there about like 6 or 7 hours, maybe like 8 hours, waiting until I was able to leave. He stayed there the same amount of time as I did, basically, and just waited until they released me because he had paid the bail and we paid the ticket and stuff like that. Got it all done as soon as I turned myself in and stuff, and they let me out as soon as all of it got processed, but it took a while. And yeah, my dad stayed there all day until I was out, and he took me home right as soon as we got done. It was crazy. Could not believe it. I guess they need to set some rules when the world's eyes are on us because of the Phantom Thieves. Stuff like, don't do anything that will hurt the scholar's reputation. Spend your summer break quietly.
I can't
stay quiet with all this excitement going on. Medjed's statement was insane. People of Japan, you must not worship the Phantom Thieves. They said it. They said it could just be a joke. There's talk that this could lead to the biggest leak of the private data to date. I wonder if they're gonna target another site. I'm curious to see how the Phantom Thieves react. It's what I'm looking forward to most this summer. It'll be the perfect escape from the exam studies. But the Phantom Thieves need to take action. They're the ones Medjed is after. This is bigger than I thought. We can't leave this be. You're right. You're fucking right.
Yep.
Mushi says, thank you for the stories. Oh yeah, no problem. I have plenty of stories. I like when they come out naturally though. Like when they're not forced, you know, it's a lot better. It's a lot better for you guys and it like makes a lot more sense. Like, I would love to do, like, every day, give you guys a little weed fact or something like that, but, it's a lot better when it comes out naturally, or like a day in the life of Stony or Stony's memories or something, you know. It's just something I can't force, because if you force it, it's just not right. It's just got to happen naturally in the moment. And yeah, for sure, for sure. I love sharing my life with you guys and being able to do all this live streaming stuff. Like, whenever I play games on my own, like lately I've been noticing that I still give a little bit of commentary out loud to myself, you know. When I was playing God of War through to the end by myself, you know, I was like, man, I should record this because this is some good, this is gold. Like, I was like, goddamn, I'm still saying shit out loud. Like, I should be streaming this, but I don't know. With God of War, I just didn't think it would be right to do it yet until people got over the spoiler territory type thing, you know. Once people have gotten the chance to either play it or like, oh, I'm not gonna play it, so fuck it, I'll watch it, you know. Once we get to that point, we'll play some God of War, and hopefully that natural chemistry just comes out of me again. An assembly during summer vacation? Are they crazy? Our school's done for. I don't care what the principal has to say. They're so stupid. I wish I could change their hearts. Why not make a post, or requests might be taken? People are at least believing in the Phantom Thieves. They're talking about the way we do our things. That's crazy. Mushu says, I feel like that with video games.
Man, that assembly had
me bored to tears. With video games are willing, right? Daddy Gamer says, boy! That is all. Boy! Right, yeah. Oh, yeah. That fucking Kratos, I swear. Mushy also says, never force it. Oh, and check out the dad jokes with Kratos. Oh, yeah. The whole thing with Kratos saying boy and all that good stuff. The freaking, I love Mimir's stories as well. Mimir does some good stuff in the boats, you know. Like, I'll even, like, if I get to the point of where I'm going to, I'll even, like, start rowing for just a little bit longer just to finish that story that Mimir's telling every time. And I'll have to check that out, Mushi. Dad jokes with Kratos. Hell yeah.
Huh? Did you have school too, Yusuke?
I'm doing laundry, so these are the only clothes I had to wear.
You really should buy a couple more outfits.
Mushi says, the actual actor saying dad jokes, though. Did you see it? I have not seen that, Mushi. I'll have to check it out, because I'm not too sure. I haven't seen it.
Come now, we didn't gather here to make small talk, now did we? Let's get to Alibaba's case. Well then, I'll start. It looks like Futaba was listening in on LeBlanc.
LeBlanc.
But why would she want to listen in on the cafe? I have no idea.
Because you guys were talking about her and her mother?
It's just like Boss said, she's a tough nut to crack.
Oh, I've cracked a lot of nuts, though.
In any case, her hacking skills will be absolutely necessary if we wish to stand up to Medjed.
Ariel says, say what you will, but saying boy is way better than Atris all the time, right? I agree with that. Boy, because I mean, like, if he was like Atreus, you know, that wouldn't have became a meme, you know. People wouldn't have had as much fun as they do with boy, you know. Like, boy, at least something comedic came out of it, you know. It gives people a smile, it makes people laugh, you know. With Atreus, you know, it's just like, it probably would have been another thing that was looked over, you know. Like, oh, hey, Atreus, come here, read this, Atreus. Like, okay, yeah, that's his name. But boy, it's just funny.
Going by what she has told us, we may even be able to identify who they are.
Mushi says, okay, I will send it to you on Twitter. Hell yeah, Mushi, I appreciate that. I'll take a look at it.
We'll have to trust in her skills for now, then.
Anyway, we found out that Futaba has a palace. But can someone who isn't evil have one? That doesn't matter. A palace is the materialization of distorted cognitions brought about by strong desires. That's all.
I realize I'm a lot like my dog. Whenever something that confuses me, like, whenever I hear something that confuses me, I always, like, twist my head like a dog does. And my dog, Baby, he does that all the fucking time. It's so funny. Like, whenever I talk to him or say something I know he won't understand, he always just tilts his head a little bit, like, what? You know, like, I can tell when he doesn't understand me and when he does, because he won't tilt his head when he understands me, but it's so crazy. Like, he's so smart. He's the smartest dog I've ever had. I need to record him as well and put him in a in a little highlights video, you know. Do, like, I need everything to come together perfectly to give you guys what I think would be decent, you know, something I think would be perfect and worthy of being seen by everybody, you know, like.
It just so happens that a lot of warped people turn out evil.
It'll happen. I just need a few things to come together first.
She's so young, though.
Drop my controller, goddammit.
Pain she's gone through must be the cause of her distortion. Maybe that has something to do with why she calls herself Alibaba.
What do you mean, Nan?
According to the chief's story, Futaba has auditory and visual hallucinations, right?
Right.
There's a chance those are related to some important memories she's holding. It's hard to explain, but those memories may have been warped by the distortions.
Basically, we just gotta steal her treasure, right?
Well, yeah.
So do we all agree about taking on Futaba's palace?
She's asked us to do so. I don't think that part is an issue.
But how's that gonna help?
If we heal Futaba's heart, it will not only help Boss, but she can then assist us with Medjet.
But every time that they've changed people's hearts, it didn't exactly do it in a positive way, you know? They kind of went catatonic until they expressed their grief, you know? I don't know. I don't know how this is gonna work, but
I agree.
I guess we'll see.
I've been wondering about how Boss said a lot happened after Futaba's mom died, too.
Hold on a second. Our investigation of her palace may not go like anything we've done up to this point.
Why's that?
Having an individual ask you to steal their heart is an extremely irregular case. There's no telling what the palace ruler's disposition will be like, or the distortion that'll be there.
Thank you very much, Mushi. I got the link for that video. I'll definitely check it out after the stream today. Thank you so much for retweeting as well. I appreciate that.
We may run into some unforeseen situations.
And Canucks fan too.
Do you still want to go in?
Canucks fan also retweeted the stream. Thank you guys. I appreciate that big time. We have a few different metaverse things. Let's do it. Let's try it. Let's figure out what the hell's going on here.
Let's just make sure we're cautious.
We only got a little bit of time left, so we might as well get some action in while we can.
Let's get cracking on those keywords, huh?
The ones we have at the moment are Futaba Sakura and Sojiro Sakura's house.
We got the who and the where, so all that's left is the what, right?
Let us try going to their house first.
Boss is busy running the cafe, isn't he? We should make sure he doesn't suspect anything.
Important memories, huh? I'll be able to remember everything if I turn back into a human, right?
I hope so, Morgana. You make it seem very sad if you won't. You sure you're a human? I hope so, Morgana.
I
want the best
for
you, buddy.
I definitely want this mission to succeed.
But in the end, if you're the one that freaking tips off the cops, I am gonna be very upset, Morgana.
If we can retrieve Futaba's memories, then I bet we can get mine back too.
We better.
In any case, it's not every day you stumble upon a hacker like her around. You really do have a gift, don't you?
You're goddamn right.
You sure live up to my expectations.
I can sense a firm resolve from Morgana. Sweet. Dwayne. Allows you to craft all infiltration tools. Nice.
Alright.
That's dope. That'll be nice. We got EXP burst. You have learned how to make ace tools from Morgana. Nice. I wonder what that means.
Hey, they went on without us. Let's hurry and catch up to them.
He just noticed we were all alone. Now Morgana, what the fuck? What the fuck? Now the last keyword. She's a shut-in, so just gotta figure out what she thinks her house is. If she can't get out, maybe a prison? Perhaps a labyrinth with an unknown exit? Maybe an oasis? Nothing so far. In that case, how about hell? We don't have nearly enough clues. Uh-oh. If only we could ask her directly. We can. Come on, let's go see Futaba. But what will we say to get in? What do you mean? We're sneaking in. You have to be joking. Won't the door be locked for sure this time? I'll take care of that. Oh, and I figured out where Futaba's room was when I snuck in last night.
Hold on.
What if we run into Boss, though? There's no way we'll be able to avoid his questions this time. He's at work now, so I think we should be fine. Getting cold feet, Makoto? Don't worry, it'll be nothing. We've gone through loads of shit like this already. It's kind of true. This is our only choice, right? I suppose Futaba did get in contact with Stony-kun. Perhaps she'll at least be willing to speak with him.
Okay.
Very well. Let's do this. Might as well.
This is Futaba's room.
Ariel says, told you, you don't need to worry about the traitor for a long time.
Yeah, but that's the way the game started. It's been in my mind. I'm still a little apprehensive on how we got caught. Mushi says, food tuba. Oh, no, that's a good one.
There's no answer. Futaba-chan, are you there? I'm sorry for being startled and screaming yesterday. It was so dark that I got scared.
No reaction whatsoever.
This is gonna be hard.
You're listening, right, Alibaba?
Ooh, someone's got a message. Well, if it ain't anybody that's already here with us, you know, I mean, I don't know who else it would be. Why are you here?
Why is she only reacting to that name? You're Futaba Sakura, aren't you?
No.
She's not responding again.
Does she not like us saying her name? We don't have time to dally around. We need her keyword before dealing with Alibaba's identity.
Maybe her keyword is her real name.
We want to learn more about you. If we don't do so, we can't steal your heart. The reason why we came here is because we need the keyword to enter your palace. That's why we want to talk with Futaba Sakura herself, not Alibaba.
That sounds a little sexual. We need the keyword to enter your palace.
You don't have to show yourself. Just answer some questions for us. Chat messages are fine.
Okay.
All right, then. Our leader, the guy who lives in LeBlanc's attic, wants to speak with you.
Why am I their leader?
We're counting on you. Try and get a keyword out of her.
Ariel says, suspecting every little thing is not healthy for you. Okay, I'll do my best not to be suspicious then. How is living in this house? It's painful. Why? I don't know.
Looks like you should ask something different.
All right, Makoto, just because you're the professional. Do you hate it? I don't.
Looks like you should.
Okay, Makoto, fuck you too. Why don't you go out? I can't leave this place. I'm going to die here.
Die?
Someone's a little emo. Is this going to continue? Die? That's right, I'm definitely going to die here. This place is my tomb.
Tomb?
Huh. Okay, so it's a tomb.
You think that's it?
It's gotta be.
Try entering tomb!
Oh yeah, here we go.
Searching for route to destination.
Uh-oh. Someone's heart's gonna be stolen today. Probably tomorrow, actually.
Yes. It was plenty.
Was that enough?
You haven't forgotten your promise of helping us if we complete your request, right?
I haven't. We made a deal.
Well then, let's hurry up and go. And clicky.
Clicky, clicky, licky, licky.
Don't activate it here!
Why? What happens if you activate it there? What's going on? Why is that bad? Uh-oh. Morgana, you need to be more specific. Stop playing the adjective name, the adjective game.
Wait, what the? Our clothes are still the same?
Right, what's up with that?
Futaba herself is asking us to steal her heart. It'd be odd if she saw us as a threat.
Adia says, welcome to the desert, baby.
If she doesn't see us as an enemy, then your clothes don't change. That's how it works.
Since when?
But more importantly, I told you to be cautious. Why'd you activate it like that?
Is that why we ended up in a desert? Where's the tomb? Oh, it's so damn hot here.
Even though we entered right in front of her room, we didn't end up inside it.
Mushi says, baby! All that baby fluff 84. Then Mushi also says, so much fluff! Right? One of these days, you guys will see him just like me with a clean cut, looking real pretty.
She must really want to keep people away from her. What a bleak feeling this place has. It's the complete opposite of Kaneshiro's bank.
Right, this is crazy.
Let's hurry up and get going. Where's the palace?
Is it that way?
Oh yeah, there's something shiny.
Azrael says, wish I could post a pic of my doggo. She's so adorable. Hey, you definitely could on Twitter or something. Definitely could check that out. Mushi says, I want to see a plain cut baby soon. Right? It'll happen. It'll happen. I'm going to take him as soon as I can.
A tomb in the desert. Anyway, let's make our way there.
Isn't that kind of far?
Are we going to walk?
Don't be lazy, guys.
Of course not. My paws will get burned.
Oh yeah, Morgana could turn into a freaking car. We're in the metaverse. Oh,
I've been waiting for this.
Fucking Yusuke. I don't think Yusuke's seen this yet.
The AC on full blast.
Lucky.
You're so considerate.
Right.
Is Morgana like good as a car though? Like, does Morgana not feel heat
as
a car?
Let's roll.
That's crazy. So many questions. Oh, we've got us an anime section here. This is gonna be nice. Love this art style as well. I've even gotten caught up on my Dragon Ball Super lately, so it's been getting crazy. It's been getting real crazy.
Yes, I know. But it still beats opening the windows to the hot desert air.
They look older than 16 and 17. I'm just gonna say that right now.
Hey, Aunt, can I have a drink? Didn't you have mineral water?
I drank it already.
Well, whose fault is that?
How are the guys?
Oh, hell no. Fucking Ryuji. You fucking perv.
Come
Wow. Oh, hell no. It wouldn't be a Japanese game without it, right? That was great. I was perving out too, so I don't blame you. I was like, you could definitely see her bra the way she's doing that. It was her own fault, you know. It's funny. Whenever me and my mom would work in our mobile taco truck together,
it's so hot.
Like, whenever there's girls that would come up and have their cleavage showing, you know, and stuff like that, I'd always tell my mom, like, it's so hard to talk to those people because you don't want to, like, look down and, like, make them feel uncomfortable, like, thinking that you're looking at them like that, you know? And, like, I try to keep it professional when I'm actually, like, taking orders and stuff. And my mom's like, don't even worry. It's their fault that they're wearing shit like that. If they didn't want to be seen, they'd cover it up. Like, I'm like, Mom, you're crazy.
The AC ain't working at all. What the hell was that lukewarm air about?
Yeah, Morgana, what the fuck?
That was the best I could do, so quit your yapping.
Yeah, well, fuck you too.
For real? You are so half-assed.
Damn, Morgana.
What was that? You want to fight, punk?
When you turned into a car, you said there'd be AC. I trusted you.
Jeez, shut up. It's hot, so don't make me more irritated. To think her palace would be a pyramid.
Hadia says your mom is great too, no question. Yeah, she definitely is, for sure. And I appreciate it, Hadia, for sure.
Hey, a pyramid's a tomb, right?
Basically, yeah.
Yes, it's a pharaoh's tomb.
That's how it's mostly known. There are a variety of theories on it.
Of course, Makoto would
know. For instance, it's even said to be a device for reviving the dead.
Reviving the dead, It's beautiful nonetheless. It's perfectly conformed to the golden ratio.
Hey guys, can we go in already?
Might as well.
I'm gonna melt. Oh, man.
Oh. Come on, let's get inside. Hold on one second, guys. I apologize. I'm getting something queued up for you guys. That way I can go make myself another drink here in a second. Are they on the sidelines right now?
Joker.
I'm ready whenever you can need me. Put me in, coach. Actually, stay here. Wait. Who do we have in right now? We've got Morgana, we've got Makoto, and we've got An. Ooh, that's a tough one. We need Morgana. I really want Ryuji, but I think the way we have things now should be okay. Like, Makoto and An are very capable of helping us out and being good teammates and stuff. But so is Ryuji. It's hard to pick. It's hard to pick between all of them. Okay, let's run inside real quick. Let's see what happens. And then after that, I'll probably go make myself a drizzank. Drinky. Gotta make sure everything is set up properly. I don't know if it is, but I hope it is. Okay, go.
It seems.
Really enjoy when they actually do their own type of narrative, but I could always read it. Audio says there's not gonna be a cutscene yet. Okay, no worries. And Mushu says, I could use a pause to order sushi. BRB, my stoner buddies. And Adia says, go make the drink. We will wait. Okay. Yeah. We'll do that real quick. We'll do that real quick. Let me make sure that this music will come on. And I'll be right back, guys. Oh. Let's see. One second. I apologize. Okay. Let's see if you guys are hearing that. No. One second, let's see.
I smell something in the air that's making me.
There we go. Now you can hear it, I think. No. That's not good.
Six pack with Exacto.
Oh
knives, I think that should be right. Lasso, big bags of the grass, zigzags, I'm with the dots, you know how that goes, skull in the crossbones, this is poison, the boys and girls,
I know you guys can hear that, but
try this at home, my love, I know, this is neither the time nor the place to get macho, so crack a six pack, sit back with some nachos, maybe some
right,
popcorn,
it. So I'll leave it like that, it should be alright. Should be all right. I'll be right back, guys.
Splitting the pill, you're submitting the skill, sitting still, I'm admitting I'm beginning to feel like I don't think anyone's real, faced with a dilemma, I can be Dalai Lama and be karma, bring drama, a step beyond a Jeffrey Dahmer, please don't upset me mama, you're looking sexy mama, don't know if it's the lala or the rum and Pepsi mama, don't wanna end up inside my refrigerator freezer, be used as extra topping the next time I make a pizza, how many people you know who can name every serial killer whoever existed in a row, put them in chronological order, beginning with Jack the Ripper, name the time and place from the body, the bag, the zipper, location of the woods where the body was dragged and then dumped, the trunk that they were stuffed in, the model to make the plate, and which model would select the founder, and how they attacked the victim, say which murder weapon was used to do what and which one, which knife and which gun, what kid would wipe and which none, don't stop, I like this, it's fun, the fucking nice to keep gun,
it's the ganja, it's the marijuana, that's creeping up on me, why I'm so high, maybe it's the hit me,
with the same stick that you're trying to light behind the boards, Dre, legends are made this way, isn't it safe to say this is the way it should be, maybe you need some lyric syrup served for your symptoms, here's a dosage of the antidote, now you give him some, he can give her some, she can give them some, get behind a lint drum, make up a beat and kill the sucker syndrome, the spinning drum when it comes to lyrics and pinning some, starting from scratch and then ending up at the ending of, capable of winning a Pulitzer, so unbelievable it's a titanium cranium that's full of sir, prizes when the smoke rises right before your very own eyes, you stare into your stereos, good evening, this isn't even a weed thing, I ain't even smoke anything, I ain't even drinking,
it must be the ganja, it's the marijuana, that's creeping up on me while I'm so high, maybe it's the hit me,
all right, here we go back again. Sorry about that, guys. Like I said, I will be getting a little refrigerator that'll be the up close and personal to me. That way, I don't have to keep getting up to make drinks like that. I'll be able to have it right next to me, and we won't miss a blink. Just give me a little while to stock up a little bit of money. That way, I could buy it and get it set into place, you know, that way we don't have to do shit like that anymore. But thank you guys so much for waiting and being patient. I appreciate it so much. You guys are amazing.
Indeed.
Yusuke knows. He says, indeed. Who knows what may await us within... What is your call, Toker? Shall we head inside? Let's do it.
Okay.
We'll find out more about Futaba's secrets in here, right?
Yes.
Adios says, welcome back, and all in due time, right? For show, for show. Makoto says, indeed. Well, let's head inside. Wow, this is, very different from all the other castles that we've visited. This is crazy. Whoa, it's so nice inside. Is this place air-conditioned or something? It may be because Futaba's room is, in reality, has AC pumping through it. Either way, this is a relief. Huh, our clothes still haven't changed even now. This has never happened to us before. Right, that's true. It is refreshing that she doesn't see us as a threat, but we are completely surrounded by balls. I guess this is a tomb. It's probably not made to be easy to get into. Anyway, let's explore, right? Let's see what we can find. We've got all kinds of mysteries to get explained, all kinds of questions that need to be answered. Like, I'm really confused about what Makoto's sister has been asking Sojiro. Like, why is he in trouble? Why is he being summoned to court and shit like that? It's not like like Alibaba is getting beaten or anything. Like, I don't know. It's crazy. I still got a lot of questions. They're way too goddamn many. Don't ask for too much. You should be happy we're not being attacked as we ascend. More importantly, I can totally sense the treasure ahead. We're getting pretty close now. These stairs seem to be headed into the heart of the pyramid. I wonder if that's where the treasure waits. Well, time to keep climbing. Let's go. Let's do it. Wait. Okay, yeah, fuck it. Let's do it. Man, no enemies or nothing. I'm all for shit like this. Oh, yeah. Hey. Do you think it's all because she's not a criminal? Mm. She did welcome us in here, after all. Don't let your guard down, guys. This is a pyramid, so there still may be traps. Right, that's true.
It's beautiful.
So this is the mystique of a bygone
time. Do you think so?
I don't think you can call this the real thing. What was I saying? Indiana Jones had traps, so don't for a second think that we're in the safe zone. Ariel says, the mini fridge, or get an even bigger cup for now. Right? Definitely. Alright, I could definitely do that. My cup right now is 32 ounces, but I'm sure I could find a bigger one. But hell yeah, some good stuff. That's some good thinking right there, Ariel, for sure. Thank you. I appreciate that. Uh-oh. Looks like we're running into fucking Alibaba right now. I forget her other name.
Hey, is this...
That's Futaba's shadow.
Futaba, okay.
It isn't the real
Gotta mentally put that in my mind and keep it there. Fucking put a post-it note pinned with a fucking thumbtack or something, you know. Futaba, boom. It's in there.
Oh, yeah, you've seen her face. True, this one's kind of dressed like a queen.
So you're Futaba Sakura.
Hey, where's the treasure?
It's doubtful that you wouldn't know where it is.
Hey, say something.
Don't be like that.
She's still kind of a shut-in then, huh?
I'm sorry, Futaba-chan. It's okay. There's no need to be scared. So, can you tell us where your most treasured possession is?
Her computer.
This is going nowhere.
Let's just leave her.
Will you guys shut up for a bit?
Right, you guys are making her nervous. Fucking calm down.
Those who plunder my tomb, why have you come?
She talked, but...
Whoa.
What are you saying? You want us to steal it, right?
If you believe you can steal it, then try as you might.
That's rather defiant sounding.
Right.
Perhaps this is that tsundere thing, where someone is harsh or sweet, depending on the mood.
Uh-oh.
Considering the state that my palace is in, there is no way that you can steal it.
Creepy child.
Uh-oh. You killed her!
You're a plague!
What are these voices?
Adria says, it's her vibrator. I called it right now. Oh, hell no.
Mother, why don't you say something?
Murderer?
You're the one who killed her!
It's your fault!
This is horrible.
One of those voices is Sojiro, I bet.
Hey, the hell is this?
Don't come near me!
Don't just stand there! Say something!
It's your fault!
No, maybe not. Maybe not.
That's right. I did it.
What?
I am the one who killed my mother.
No.
What was that?
My mother exists here.
What
I
the
will
fuck?
Remain here. I will do so until I die.
Our clothes.
She sees us as a threat now. What's going on?
What the fuck? What is going on here, ladies and gentlemen?
This again. Creepy child.
You killed her!
You're a plague, murderer!
Why don't you say
You're
something?
You're the one who killed her!
That's right. I killed Mom. I don't deserve to be alive.
Futaba.
This place is a tomb. I'll die here.
No way.
That's right. Die!
Don't come near me!
Don't just stand there! Say something!
It's your fault!
No! Someone help me!
What the fuck? This is getting dark. Poor Futaba, man. I don't even know. What the hell? This is bad. I'm having a hard time getting a grasp of our situation. We should regroup and... What now? Oh crap! Bad, bad, bad! Run! This is exactly like Indiana Jones now. What the fuck? Lucy says she'd need that G1 love. Oh yeah, for sure. The G1s can change anybody's mood. I believe that 100%. G1s are the best. You guys have probably saved so many lives. We've brought so many people in as new friends, and we have so many old friends. You know, like G1s are the best group on the internet for show. That is one thing I will never ever change my mind on, because yeah, you guys have helped me through some tough times. You've helped so many other people through tough times, you know. The G1, like the G1 tag is a special honor to be a part of, for sure. Now what? Even if we wanted to ask Futaba what's going on, it seemed the door is shut. What should we do now? I think our best option is retreating for now. This won't be as simple as we expected. Why don't we prepare a little more, then come back? Good idea, my thoughts exactly. Well, thank you for giving me a choice, video game. good idea, I guess. Okay, then let's retreat for now and return to the palace another day. That kind of sounds like some Santana freaking guitar playing right there.
The date that Medjid has set for the alleged cleanse is 8/21. That day is fast approaching.
Well, no shit, you can't stop time, TV reporter.
The Phantom Thieves, whom they singled out, have not made any notable actions at this time.
For all you know, you don't know about the metaverse.
Will Medjid carry out their cyber terrorism?
They just might.
In order to stop them, we need to help Futaba Sakura before the 21st. Our deadline is about 2 days prior, so the 19th.
Uh-oh.
Meeting up in Shibuya, then coming here is a pain, right? Let's make this place our hideout for a while.
I don't know about that, man. Akichi, fucking, he figured you guys out real easily. This is convenient.
Is everyone fine with this place being our next hideout, then?
I guess.
We must take care not to be discovered by Boss.
Or get Boss into any trouble, you fucking assholes.
There's no telling what may happen inside that pyramid. We all need to be cautious so that place doesn't become our graveyard.
Man, this is gonna be one crazy summer vacation. We're dealing with international hackers and looking for a treasure in a pyramid.
How can you be enjoying this? This is a crisis of whether or not our group continues on, you know?
Yeah, Ryuji, you fucking asshole.
I know that.
That reminds me. While we were in the Mona car, you were staring at me with a dirty look, you perv.
He's not the only one.
Shut up. It was a great view.
Oh, hell no.
You guys were looking too, am I right?
Yeah, he's right.
Indeed. The pyramid's golden ratio was truly a sight to behold.
Yusuke, I'm a little concerned about you, buddy.
It ain't what I'm talking about.
I wasn't staring Lady on. I'm a gentleman.
Shut the fuck up, Morgana. You don't even know. If you weren't staring, then you don't know what we're talking about.
It's not that you weren't, but that you couldn't since you were transformed. Am I right?
Han's right. Han's 100% right.
Will we be all right like this?
I hope so. Your hideout has moved from the Shibuya Teikyo building accessway to the Yogen Jaya Cafe LeBlanc. Ariel says, there's always the illusion of choice in this type of games, right? I definitely get that. Oh. Uh-oh. Her keyboard is like mine. I feel so a part of this story. Poor girl. Like, seriously. I would feel so bad. Especially, like, I love my mom so much. And, like, having anything to happen to her would be just devastating. Well, that sucked. Is doing this really going to help us do something about MedJet? Do they truly intend to follow through on their threat? It'd be a shame if our efforts were a waste. MedJet will definitely make a move. Alibaba? I'm checking in on your progress. How much longer will it take? Your heart is more problematic than we anticipated. Hey, Alibaba. Can you really do something about MedJet? Of course. Unfortunately, we have next to no evidence to support that. Your work will be rewarded, I promise. Besides, you have no other option, do you? I suppose that's true. Can you do stuff like take down a server? Show us. Hey, don't start any trouble. That's all it would take to convince you? Alright, I ask that you take care of this quickly. Until then. Wait, are you ditching us again? This is troubling, but we need to do what we can at the moment. I have concern for Futaba herself during all this. Man, why'd this have to be during summer vacation? We don't have any other choice. Stony-kun, as always, we'll leave the call... Or we'll leave it to you to call us together. Man, we're like the Avengers over here, fucking A. The sight of her palace bothers me too. We have to do this.
Okay.
Damn you, Morgana, controlling every aspect of my life. Hey, listen up. This is horrible. The fan site is gone. I try to access the URL, but it says the page doesn't exist. The fruit of my labor has completely disappeared. Oh, do you think it's because of MedJet? Oh, I don't even know. Fuck. It has to be. Is this supposed to be some kind of penalty for cheering for the Phantom Thieves? But wait, they're totally jumping the gun. There's still time until the cleanse. Hold on, something came up. Is this proof enough for you? What's that supposed to mean? Do you think it's a virus? Oh. What is it now? Well, it looks like everything's back to normal. Sorry for making a fuss about all this. I'm going to try to look into it a little more, though. See you. What? Was that Alibaba proving that she's what she said earlier? Talk about a crazy thing to pull off. I don't know. That was a little weird, guys. I don't know if that's Alibaba or what. I don't know what to make of that. That's weird.
Hey.
Our main objective here is defending MedJet, Our main objective here is defeating MedJet, so we can't rest even after we steal Futaba's heart. Understand? Don't tell me we gotta go to bed. Oh, you fucking bitch, Morgana.
Okay.
For the honor of the Phantom Thieves, we have to go beat MedVed. Everybody said, go to MedVed. MedVed must be bored. MedVed is dangerous. Is MedVed worse than the Mafia? Probably. Criminal catfight, eh? Go on, Phantom Thieves.
Now then.
Helping Futaba isn't the end, you know that, right? We need her to help us take down MedVed. Got it? Okay, then. Let the plan commence. The plan to change Futaba's heart has begun. Try to steal your target's heart by the deadline. Okay, so it's basically like every other castle we've gone against. Requests will appear on the Phantom Aficionado website. As rumors of the Phantom Thieves spread, use these tips to track targets in the Mementos. Exploring Mementos and defeating shadows is an effective way to gain experience. Grow stronger and defeat familiar and rare shadows in Mementos. Huh. Okay, so, do we have enough things to go into Mementos, Ariel? Ariel says, there's always the illusion of choice in these times. Oh, I already read that one, sorry. Ariel also says, you are free now. Use your time wisely. That is, Wait. Let's look at our IMs real quick. Let's see what's going on here. What are you doing today? From Makoto. What are you doing today, Stony-kun? I just finished up some student council work. I have some things to take care of, and I'll be in the school's vicinity. Let me know if you need anything. Seems like Makoto's at school. Want to go see her for a bit? Let's check out our other options real quick. Are you going today? If you'll be infiltrating the palace, be sure to gather everyone. Well, what do you want to do? Should we meet up at the hideout and head into the palace? Let's take a look at what An wants to do. What are your plans for today? I'm in Shibuya right now. If we're meeting up, I can get there quickly. I'll still be in the station for a bit, so let me know if anything comes up. Should we go with An? Let's look at our map for a second. Let's see what the best choice would be. Takemi's not about to level. An is not about to level. Makoto. We could go with Makoto and she might level up a little bit. Let's hang out with Makoto. I feel like that might be a good waste of our time. Where are you, Makoto? Right here. There we go. Let's do it. Let's hang out with Makoto. Go right away. What's up, Makoto? How you doing, girl? I'll be in front of the school entrance. Oh yeah, you better be ready. I'm gonna smash it like it's never been smashed before.
Hey!
Oh, Stony-kun, have you decided on our plans for today? Yeah, let's hang out, bro. Just me and you. At a time like this? I guess if that's really what you wanted to do, is this part of your grand strategy? Yeah, that's exactly right, girl. I suppose it wouldn't hurt to take things a little slower. About our trip to the Red Light District, do you have time today? Sure. It's good to take a break every so often. Do you want to hang out with Makoto? You're goddamn right.
Alright then.
Alright, let's take the train there. Well, I'm gonna go take a walk while you're busy with her. Let me know when you're ready to leave. We're gonna be busy all night. And you best believe it. Morgana. There are so many people here. I guess this is really the biggest red light district in Asia, huh? Apparently this place was a hotbed for criminals and illegal immigrants before they installed surveillance cameras. I heard there were quite a few brothels as well. You are very informed. Have you been here before? Stay close to me. You are very informed.
Yes.
Well, I heard a great deal about it from my father. This is the first time I've actually been here myself, though. Hey, we got two of those notes, so that's not too bad. 2 and 2. You guys get it? Hell yeah. Regardless, it's become far safer now than it used to be. Of course, the surveillance cameras played a substitutional role in that. But it was mainly thanks to the police efforts to clean up the area. Even so, there's no way to eradicate crime entirely. It seems the operations nowadays are only better hidden.
Shall we go?
Anyway, seeing is believing, yes? Come on, let's have a look around. Let's do it. At Makoto's request, we walked separately through Shinjuku. Countless men tried to start conversation with her. Well, she is pretty. Did we lose him? That guy was so persistent.
Oh my.
He must have been a scout for a hostess club. He mentioned how his girls get paid a lot to wear cute dresses. All I wanted was to ask if any Shujin students worked there, but he nearly dragged me inside with him. If you hadn't been there to rescue me, I... that was dangerous.
Yes.
Yeah, we got two. That's not bad. For him, maybe. I thought I was going to have to knock him out. I'm glad nobody had to get hurt, though. Yeah. I guess that's how they do it. I've learned something new today.
Thank you very much.
Oh, and thanks again. It seems you have a knack for helping me out. I hope I can do the same for you someday. I can feel quite motivated from Makoto. Sweet. Let's see. Audio says, leave mementos for next time. It's 30 minutes away from GA stream anyway. Yeah. I think you're right there. For sure. Mushi says, okay, I'm back. I'm sorry, Mushi, but I think we're about to end this real quick. Let's see. Allows you to pass your turn over to other baton pass users after a one more. Sweet. That's cool. All right. That's not bad. We could, like, go back and forth between different people. That's pretty cool. That aside, even though this is a shopping district, there are absolutely no students here. And definitely no Shujin students, though. I guess they wouldn't come in uniform either way. Well then. What about this? Makoto, what are you seeing? That person has a Shujin outfit. That was...
Did you notice this? I used to be
in the same class as her. But why is she here? She's probably stripping for money. An after school salon. Why is it called a salon? What kind of place is that? I'm not sure, but it seems suspicious. I'll have to ask her about it. Oh, and I'd like you to be there too, as my witness. Would that be okay? I guess. Well, we spent quite a bit of time here. Let's head back to the station.
All right,
Pussy.
Then.
Thank you for today. Yeah, we're getting pretty close to that. Oh yeah, Makoto. You and the teacher and Han, all y'all gonna be mine. What's gonna happen if we hit Medjet's deadline? I'm sure the Phantom Thieves will do something about it. We don't even know who Medjet is. What can they do about it? August 21st is the deadline, right? I can't wait. Aw, man, we have to wait a whole month? They're going crazy. Mushi says, thanks, Jake. No worries, and
back.
Lovely night for y'all. See you. Yeah, no worries, Mushi. Thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate it so much. And we'll see you next time. Just what's Medjet gonna do? It is hard for me to even fathom what it could be. Probably have really been up in arms about the whole cleansing thing. Audio says, save. Oh yeah, we will, no worries. As soon as I can, I will. To think a global hacker group would be targeting us. Should we ignore them? We have to act. Sure, but no matter how you look at it, we need a countermeasure. Our best bet would be Alibaba, but she may not be capable of it in her current state. I guess we should think of some other ways too then. Yes, it would be best to have as many solutions as possible. Well, we still got time, so let's come up with something good, okay?
All right, yeah.
Let's save real quick. Let's make sure we got everything in order, make sure everything's all proper looking and stuff like that. Oh, yeah. We've done a little bit of like 3 minutes of overtime, but, you know, it's all good. Definitely love having you guys interact in the chat, you know, and love being able to play this with all you guys watching and all you guys as invested as I am, you know, and just makes it so much better. And, you know, so much thanks to all you guys for joining me, and thank you so much. We'll see you guys tomorrow. I'm going to be streaming tomorrow for sure. Same time, same place. You'll be able to see it. We'll probably continue more of this Persona 5. I'm not too sure. Maybe some of the less. I don't know. We'll see. I might do like a little poll on Twitter. We'll see what happens. I don't know. But yeah, it's going to be some good stuff. We'll see you guys next time. 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. And thank you guys for joining me. We'll see you guys next time. Peace out.